Hello and welcome to another episode of my Battletech Extended 3025 mod career. And I've been away for a week. I was ill. I couldn't talk without it hurting, but I'm fine now. And against the vicious rumours that Catch is trying to spread, I'm definitely not a bot. Look, I've got hands and stuff. Bots don't have hands. Right, so let's see. Where was I? Oh, my voice is sounding a little bit croaky already. Excuse me. Sorry. So we were left in a location. Can I have my voice back? Yep, seems I can. We were left in a location with two more missions to do. Remember, we'd just taken on our latest member of the crew, which was Cold Steel. So thanks very much for your subscription, Cold Steel 3025. So we got him created, and we were busy working on a mech, because he's a big fan of the Warhammer, so I thought we'd wheel out a Warhammer. So yeah, that's being built. And I guess we're upgrading the weapons on the Highlander 733P. But we've got these contracts here. So I guess we'll do this for Skull to start with. Right. We'll leave it there. Okay, what do we got? Martian environment, eh? Right. Well, let's take some people that are here out. So some of the loyal early shower uppers. Even though I've been away for a week. Well, should we take? Oh, I'm injured. Yeah, I'll probably leave it at that, I think, for now. I need another mech, though. My God. Right, can I have my voice back to normal? I think I can. Not sure what to do here. Maybe I'll switch that there and we'll take the charger. Yeah, that seems all right to me. Okay, so yeah, let's go with that. Sarge says should call his Warhammer the Steel Hammer. That's a good idea, Sarge. Yeah. Today's newspaper or riot, says Catch. Oh crap. Don't have a newspaper. I haven't had a newspaper since like the 90s. Pacifist says, was that a Judas Priest song between a Warhammer and an anvil? Sounds like it could have been. Sarge says, tea sweetened with honey will help your voice. What? No vodka? I'm not sure. Are you the real Sarge? Are you a Sarge bot? You know what it is? It's because I didn't do Football Manager on Friday, because I was ill. That's what my voice is missing. It needs its Football Manager commentary exercise. Did you guys notice that there's music now? I've got music up for the show starting page. Don't know if anyone was aware of that or whether you're just muted while it's on show starting. Catch says, yes, that music was awesome. It's actually my dad's band from, when was that? And that was recorded in the mid-90s. That was from a live gig. I think that one was recorded when they were playing in Germany at some point. At some festival. But yeah. I quite like those tunes. It's decent enough hype music. And of course, free from copyright issues because it's my dad's. So I'm all good there.
Up Affirmative.
No worries, pacifist. Hopefully see you soon. Right. Let's head to this patch of dust there, I think.
On it. Confirm.
Yeah, copyright's getting worse and worse as time goes on, isn't it? Well, for content creators anyway, it's getting more and more difficult. Obviously, I've never used music on my stream, but that music I'm using on my starting page now, obviously I'm all good to use that. Also, you know, there's a bunch of music from bands that I've been in that I could use, but my dad's... That particular band of my dad sounds a lot more Irishy, although there is one that he plays with. It's even more Irishy sounding, called The Crack. What am I gonna do here? Go for vigilance, I think. Get some protection. But yeah, he still plays a lot of music with a variety of bands, even though he's in his mid-60s now. Catch says, not everyone can just ask Deadmau5 to make them a custom intro. Yeah. Pretty sure I couldn't get that from Deadmau5.
Copy that. Reporting critical hit. They've got a sensor lock on me.
That doesn't surprise me at all, Sarge. Sarge says, I'm becoming famous. While watching other streamers while you were sick, a few of them recognized my name from talking about disgusting foods. There are better things to be known for, but yeah. That will do. Yeah, I imagine things will be a little bit quiet today until people realize I'm back. Hey, Rylan, how you doing? Good to see you, mate.
I'm showing minor damage.
Oh, you missed the new starting soon music.
Standing by.
You have to get here early tomorrow, Rylan.
I copy.
Sarge says, hey, I'll take what I can get. Isn't that the jackass philosophy on getting famous? They took what they could get. It worked, to be fair. They did get famous.
Roger that.
Is it Miley Cyrus, says Ryland? No, it is not Miley Cyrus. I would get a copyright claim for using that. No, this is music that I can't get done for copyright for.
Need something, Chief?
What's up, boss?
Speaking of which, pretty sure I've got the music turned off in-game, haven't I? Yeah. There we go. Have some atmosphere. What to shoot next? Well, that Banshee's got an AC-20. Probably, yeah, but this Highlander's not got any kind of damage mitigation, so yeah, we're going to shoot the Highlander. Shall we go for precision strike, or what? Yeah, let's do it.
Whatever you say, boss.
That was not really worth it, was it? Not sure anything other than that single PPC hit the center.
Yes, Commander.
Okay. What is Ryland going to wreck today? Guess it'll have to be the Banshee because he can't see anything else.
Targeting for an Alpha strike.
Otto, how you doing? I'm good, thank you. Yeah, I was ill. I couldn't really talk without pain and a lot of it. I've still got a bit of an ear infection as well, which I had at the same time. So this ear keeps popping every now and then. Just really annoying. It's like I'm on a flight, but I'm not. But I can deal with that, because at least I can talk now. Hey, Garrisoned. Yes, I'm feeling a lot better than I was, thank you. Still not 100%, but good enough to stream.
What's up, boss?
Oh, another Stalker. Stalkers everywhere. Ah, the Banshee's lost his AC-20 now, so he's a lot less of a threat. So, no, that's not what I want to shoot. So I'm going to shoot this Stalker up instead. Because he's got a lot of firepower, even though it's a Stalker 4P. It's, of course, the 75-ton heavy version of the Stalker, but still packing a lot of firepower. Oh, you had to start a new campaign, Hotto? Have I missed? I've missed stuff, haven't I? Oh no.
Receiving you.
I'm gonna have to go back through the videos and figure out what I missed, Hotto.
Hey there.
What to do here? I guess Catch will shoot at the Banshee because he couldn't get into range to shoot at either of those. So this will have to do. Oh, I've got to see that catch.
Commander.
Right.
Commander.
Sarge is getting a little bit too hot, and of course, lacking coolant vent, he's only going to get hotter. I'm going to have to switch some PPCs off. Am I going to have to switch two off? I am going to have to switch two off. Okay. Let's go with that one. That does the extra stability damage. And we'll shoot the Stalker 4P.
Ready for orders.
This guy's getting a little bit too close for comfort, isn't he? I think he might be coming in for a punch, and Banshees have a very scary punch, so I think I'm going to shoot his leg off. There you go. I'll slow him down.
Solid connection on that one.
Yeah, I want to know that as well, Sarge. What did Hotto get?
That's it. Now it's showtime.
I suppose I should try to finish that guy off while he's down, shouldn't I?
Ready for
probably dual AC-20s will do for that job. Assuming they both hit the center. There we go, job done. Stalker's gone out of view. Am I going to be able to get a view on him with anyone?
Waiting for orders.
Is that a view on the Stalker? I think it is. Let's go for that. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's what I want, because I want to keep shooting this guy. Can Sarge afford to switch on a second PPC? He can, that's good.
Engaging with target.
Gotta love all those heat sinks this mech has. Very, very useful. Hey, Infernal. Trolling as usual, I see.
Receiving you.
How are you doing?
Roger.
Says it's not trolling if you know it's a joke.
Target's taken a critical hit.
Order. Fire.
They're still pretty tough, these Stalkers. Even though they're 10 tons lighter than the Assault version, still take a lot of beating to get through them. Right, now I'm going to have to rely on sensor lock, which is fine, because everyone could do with cooling down, and I can probably afford to just brace up with the other guys and fire at this Stalker with Rylan, who has obviously now twisted himself to show his more armoured side. Actually, the Highlander's in view as well now, isn't he?
Damage is minor. Yes, Commander.
Good to go.
How's the stream doing for you guys? Just had a couple of messages about dropped frames, which doesn't normally happen if everything's fine. So just let me know if it's affecting the stream at all.
Roger that. Solid connection on that one. Got something you want done?
Nope, that's not what I want. Yeah, that will do. And again, Sarge will have to reduce down to one PPC for this round. Oh, manages a headshot with that. That'll do. Alright, Halcyon. Can we get you a view on that Stalker? We can. That will do.
I'm there.
Hoping to blow that side torso off it at this point, and then it will be neutered.
You got it.
In terms of having any guns, no, it's not going to happen. Tasku Plays Games. Hello, that's a new name in chat. How are you doing? And welcome to the stream. He says, I see Sarge has a character in play here. Yep. Sarge is one of my loyal subscribers. All of my pilots in this playthrough are subscribers.
Ready for orders.
Good to go.
Commander, ready to get it on. Moving out.
Okay, let's switch that second PPC on. Can I switch three on? No, three's far too hot. Two will do then. The Stalker's managed to back out of sight for now, which is annoying, but we'll just start work on the Highlander for now, I think. Haskew says, I seen Sarge surfing other channels, nice. Now I see him here doing the damage.
Crap. That hit hard. Waiting for orders.
Things are a little bit toasty. Alright, we can still do a reasonable amount of damage. Even when hot in this environment. And shouldn't be too many turns until coolant vents ready again with most of them. So two turns away for Halcyon. It's not so bad, is it, really? Turn the large laser off. Just fire the AC-10s. That'll do. Knocked this Highlander down, which is nice.
Yes, Commander. Copy that.
Time to step up with the Atlas. Now he's down. Let's drill him with a couple of AC-20s to the center. Yeah, that'll do nicely. Come on, don't miss. I look good. Look good. He's open. Right. Well, first order of business needs to be taking advantage of this guy that's down. And let's try to finish him off. What's he got? 106. So, really, I just need to hit him with a single AC-20 and he's toast. There we go. That'll do. And the Stalker's almost dead as well. Shouldn't take too much to finish him off.
Commander.
Rylan is one turn away. Being able to use coolant vent. Still get away just about with firing two LRM-15s. Might be all I need, really, to strip off that side torso.
Locked on.
Tasku's asking, does the Flashpoint DLC work with this mod? Yes, it absolutely does. I'm using it right now. It works just fine with this mod. Right, what's left of that CT? Okay, Sarge can finish this, I think. Bosh, bosh, job done. Nice. And I don't see any sign of reinforcements. So, yeah, I think we're all good here.
Mission
awesome. Yes, he does, Tasku. He was piloting the Atlas just now. There he is. Right. Nothing of consequence happened, so we're all good. What are we going to salvage? Let's look, see if there are any decent weapons. Oh, hold on a minute. Hold on. We'll have that. And we'll have that. And we'll ignore everything else, I think. Yep, comm system and a gyro will do me nicely. And we got a couple of Stalker pieces as well. Not too bad. Oh, welcome back, Hotto. Yeah, we were wondering what mechs you got for your starting lineup for your restart of your challenge. What mechs did you get to start with this time? An urban mech, a cicada, a wasp, a locust, and a fire starter. Oh my god. Well, the fire starter's good. Oh, you are so screwed again. You got a cicada. Oh my god. I'd rather have a locust over that. Yeah, the Irby's nice. The trouble with it is keeping it up with your other fast light stuff though, isn't it? But if you can manage that, they are useful. You got 3 mech kills with the AC-10 and only 8 shots. Nice. Yeah, I one of my careers I was lucky enough to start with an urban mech, and they are pretty nice. But the fire starter is an awesome mech to start with. Well, actually, hold on. You don't respec, do you? You're stock mechs only, so that does change things a little bit. But yeah, so I suppose the Irby's probably better than the fire starter if you're just talking about stock stuff. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, if you're not restricting yourself to Hotto's rules. The Firestarter is a great mech to start with. You can respec that into something good immediately. Right. Let's move on to the next contract. Still getting drop frames now and then. What's going on with this? Hold on. Let me see if I can shut a load of things down, see what's going on. What's causing that? Okay, clear that and see if it happens again. Right, but you guys are definitely, you're not noticing anything wrong with the stream or anything like that. Nobody's complaining anyway. But yeah, it's giving me notifications. Okay, what are we doing here? Capture base, Martian, 4.5 skull. Right. Tasku says, if you roll with the fire starter, you've got to play Prodigy with it. Classy. All right, let's switch things up a bit. I need some coolant vent ability. Oh, I got rid of the longbow, didn't I? Yeah, I did. That was so I could bring the Warhammer out. That's right, I remember now. So I don't have. Oh, hold on. I could use that, couldn't I? Yeah, let's bring that out. And what else should I do here? Take another pilot out, but yeah, nobody else has really got the hot environment stuff. I suppose I should take Shell out and make the most of the high spirits. That could be useful. Okay, that'll do. Catch says, any Americans remember how back in the day Prodigy was supposed to bring whatever it is they call that music then? Techno to the States. Techno, is that what they called it? Prodigy were their own thing, man. They were something different. Hold on. Yes, you can, Hotto, but just give me a sec so I can do the command. Look, I'm getting my sheet of paper out with the instructions on. Right, permit. Okay, there you go. Yay, it worked. Catch says, US was like shrug, back to grunge until the Matrix or something. Right, what is this link? Let me see. Oh my god. Is that your colour scheme? That is something else. That is quite special. Oh my god. It's festive. The viewers pick the colour. Oh yeah, yeah, I remember you do that, don't you? Yeah, that's what you get. That is what you get when you let the viewers pick your colours. It looks like an Easter egg, so Sarge. It really does. Oh man, I suppose I should show the YouTubers what we're talking about, really, shouldn't I? Alright. Dan. Oh no, not that. Need that. Editor. That one. There we go. There you go, YouTube. Now you can see that. That's the paint scheme for Hotto's new company. Isn't it hideous? It looks like something people would have worn in the 90s. Right. Okay, now where was I? We've got a base to destroy, and it's all the way over there. Okay. Okay, I guess I'll head towards this little patch of dust. Oh no, there's a patch of dust there as well. We'll go that way then. All about hiding in the dust in this environment.
Affirmative. Copy that.
Catch was saying about Otto's colour scheme. Is that an Easter egg scheme? Or is the hideout ripe with hallucinogens? Maybe both?
Copy that.
Roger that.
Roger that.
Time to earn our money.
I mean, Sarge, it could be strategic. It's like camo, but instead of actually working as a camouflage, it just hurts the eyes of the enemy gunners so much that they can't actually bear to look at it to shoot straight. It could be a winner. What are we up against? 285s and a 70 tonner so far. Oh my god, all of those could potentially be LRM mechs. That's scary. Yep, okay, so the 70 tonner is an archer.
Waiting for orders. Position confirmed.
Not what we want to see in this environment. Let's see if I can nail it as quickly as possible. Sarge says I actually wore something like that back in the 60s. I could totally believe that, yeah.
Good to go.
Hotto says his cicada has fancy boots. God, show that as well. Oh dear. There it is, YouTube. Fancy boots cicada. Tasku says, is the Razzle Dazzle camo the one you see and you can't aim because you laugh so much?
Ready,
yeah.
Four orders.
Could be that.
On my way. Confirm.
Just die already. Come on. Fall over. Oh, he's not dead. At least I've blown half of it away now, so it won't have quite so many LRM-20s. Infernal says double archer and longbows. That's what I'm worried about, Infernal. Obviously, we've seen the archer. Lone Man Wolf has hosted me. Thank you very much. And it looks like I've had some offline stuff going on as well while I've been away. So, Little Fuzz 3313, thank you very much for the follow. Krig 0077, thank you very much for the follow. And Emperor Krang, thank you very much for the sub. Apparently, my OBS has just caught up with a bunch of activity that's been going on while I was away ill.
Location confirmed. On.
Oh, I love that catch. Catch says that cicada trampled a bunch of the guys from Avatar on the way home from a Grateful Dead concert. Perfect. That is just perfect. Okay, what's this? Quick draw. We've got to nail him because he's clearly going to be spotting for those 85 tonners back there. At least we've now made a smudge on the ground out of that archer, which is a good start for us.
Targeting for an alpha strike.
Hello, Lone Man Wolf. Well, that was some kind of missiles. I mean, that could be a Stalker. I guess it could also be a Battlemaster still at this stage. I don't know. We'll find out soon enough. But first things first, we need to wreck this quick draw. Because that's what's providing line of sight. Let's make the most of those high spirits that Shell has right now. And we'll go for the CT shot. Really need to get her called shot mastery, though. Infernal says, I rate that this attempt LRM-10. Yeah, could have been, couldn't it? It seemed like that, didn't it? Which means, I mean, we know it's not a longbow, because that would have fired a lot more missiles. But it could be one of the Battlemaster variants, or technically one of the Stalker variants just firing a single LRM-10. We'll have to see what they are. Nice. Right, quick draw down.
Down.
We made quick work of that quick draw.
No retreat.
Yep. Awful puns. Okay, I need a sensor lock. I need to know what one of those is. Go for this guy at the front. And it's Stalker 3F. Okay, so that has a couple of LRM-10s. It must have fired a single one for whatever reason. There you go, two LRM-10s on that. Ryland's the only one that's going to be able to shoot at this. Can he get into the rear arc? Can, but it means breaking cover. I mean, that might be worth it.
Coordinates received.
Let's have a crack. And we're going to go precision strike and just try to drill all of these missiles into that rear center. Not the best weapons to do that with, but since we've got the opportunity, may as well make the most of it.
Reporting critical hit.
Did we seriously just blow off both torsos? This is why precision strikes are not that great with missiles. We went for the center rear, and somehow we managed to blow off both side torsos instead. I mean, we very nearly got that rear as well, but I mean, it's still a win because he's now got no weapons. So I'd say it was worth it, but another demonstration of why precision strikes with missiles are not that great. But, you know, if they're the only weapon you're going to be able to shoot with, sometimes it's worth it. Or if you've got so much resolve that you don't know what to do with it, it can be worth it. Lone Man Wolf says, hope your destroying goes better than mine. 2 withdrawals due to bugs and 2 from running into horrible situations from my bad play. Oh dear. What were the bugs you encountered then? I thought they'd fixed a lot of them with the last harebrained patch.
Well done. Here we go.
I did have one, actually. I had one where I destroyed both the legs on a mech and it wasn't dead. I think someone clipped it and called it the Lieutenant Dan bug. Was that Hotto clipped that? I forget now. Somebody did. But yeah, I blew off both its legs and it still wouldn't die. Yeah, Lieutenant Dan. Yeah, that's right. What's going on? I've got to do stuff here, haven't I? Let's kill the mechs. Lone Man Wolf says, both times were capture base missions where only 3 out of 4 of the reinforcements spawned and can't complete the mission. Oh man, that's frustrating. And are you playing vanilla, or are you playing BattleTech Extended 3025 or Rogue Tech? What version of the game are you on? Catch says, you're playing Extended 3025. Interesting. Well, welcome to the Extended 3025 streamer family. Hey, even more now. Yeah, that's concerning.
What's up?
Catch says, I got the big steel crab bug today. I thought they fixed that, Catch. The big steel crab bug. I thought Harebrained had fixed that. That's weird.
Waiting for orders. Heading out. Giving him everything I've got.
Yeah, that he says, me too. First time I'd seen it since the fix. Yeah, that's a strange one.
Orders.
These guys are being really awkward and just not coming into view and popping over their cover, are they? So I think I'm going to have to go engage them directly. What's my best angle of approach? I'm not entirely sure. I don't want to get shot up by the base turrets. That's a concern. We might have to do a sensor lock on that and get the missiles into play.
Yes, Commander.
Catch says, it was kind of an edge case because I had to pull 4 mechs out for that Marek flashpoint. Okay.
How's it going?
Yeah, that's got to be worth reporting to Harebrained then, because perhaps they don't know that could still occur. Because yeah, I thought they'd fix that completely. I guess not. Oh, you idiot. I didn't move far enough to be able to sense lock that turret. Never mind. We'll sense lock a mech instead. Keep raining missiles on it. Well, we know one of those is completely neutered and can't do anything. So he's going to have to, well, can't do anything, can't do much. He can still attack in melee, but he doesn't look like he's got any intention of doing that at the moment. He's just wandering around aimlessly.
Position confirmed.
But the other guy still has some weapons, so we'll try to smash him up. Catch says, bottom line, the BSC-27 should never leave storage for a variety of reasons. The main one being that it's rubbish. But yeah. All right. I don't know what the AI is doing here. It seems confused. It's going backwards and forwards and just letting me shoot the crap out of it there. So, yeah, I'm going to try to put it out of its misery by just aggressively engaging it now. Now it'll actually be able to shoot back. But, yeah, that's weird behavior from it there. And I assume it's because of this terrain. And it not being quite sure what to do in response. Lone Man Wolf says, gonna lurk while I find some food and eat my meds for dessert. Interesting dessert. Otto says, rubbish is good when compared to other rubbish. That's true, yeah. If all you've got is locusts and cicadas, then I'm sure you'd be happy to have that big steel crab. Sarge says, by the way, watched Harbin yesterday and saw for the first time in the new 0.999 the forest actually catching fire. Awesome. So the forests can now catch fire in Rogue Tech. That's pretty cool. I like the sound of that. Does it burn all the trees down so that they're no longer usable as cover, though? Because that's... I would like that less if it just removed all the cover. But yeah, that's some pretty cool work, whoever's done that.
Got it.
Hotto says, can you put the fire out with coolant vent? That should totally be a thing, Hotto. I'm in favour of that.
We can salvage that.
Tasku says, it does remove cover, yes, and it causes heat damage. Oh my god.
Receiving you.
How easy is it to set fire? Do you have to use flamer weapons to set fire to the trees, or just firing lasers? Will that set fire to them as well? Is it going to be one of those ridiculously brutal things? Ah, right, so it doesn't automatically just spread. Sarge says there's a 20% chance of catching adjacent spaces on fire as well. Okay, so it could just burn itself out. I just had pictures of it. You know, you fire a medium laser into a forest and suddenly all of the cover's gone on the entire map and you're just left going, oh, well, shit. Now what? What am I going to do?
Sensors locked on.
Tasku says it also introduces a bug to the game, like levitating fires above battlegrounds. Oh. needs a bit more work then. Otto says, confirmed, drop in the Lance of Firestarters and watch the world burn. Yep.
Copy that.
Okay, that's painful. There's clearly a heavy LRM turret back there. So you can now target the landscape as well, says Sarge from that. Okay, so yeah, you can just strategically decide to shoot up some cover. Hmm. Hotto says, good, about time we can blind fire the LRMs. You're supposed to get 15 inches of snow tomorrow. It is April, isn't it? Where are you, Catch? Are you in Canada? Where are you?
Yes, Commander.
15 inches of snow in April.
Commander? Affirmative.
Jesus. Ryland says probably US Central. It's supposed to be bad. Lots of flooding. Yeah, that's not good. Like, it feels like summer today to me here. It's already stupidly warm. Did we swap weather? Like, did Britain and America swap weather? Was there some deal that happened that we're not aware of?
Yes, Commander. Got it. Run, don't shoot.
Hey, Cold Steel, how you doing? Good to see you. Catch says that's a shit trade if we did. No, it sounds like a good trade. Well, actually, we wouldn't want your extreme weather. We don't want the hurricanes and all of that, tornadoes and whatnot. Cold Steel says, okay, nice and sunny here in the Midwest.
Ready for orders. Moving to position.
Which end of the US is Sarge from?
Locked on.
The ass end.
What's up, bud?
<Mark? laughs>
I've got a sensor lock.
Oh, well, what do you class as the ass end, though? Like,
good to go.
Is it California? Is it Texas? Is it Florida? Which bit counts? Or do all of those count? Darius there with the warning. Oh, the base has got guns and stuff. Like, really? We've destroyed half of them. Thanks for that useful intel. Osage is in North Carolina. Okay.
Need something, Chief? How's it going? On the move.
He says, keep it up, Catch, and the Food Network will start. Is it already approaching lunchtime?
Got a lot.
Otto says, Florida is hot garbage. I would know. I've lived there for most of my life. You're in Florida. All right. The thing I know about Florida is the Florida man meme. That's all I know about Florida. And it's warm. So basically, most Florida men are crazy, weird criminals, and it's warm. That's what the internet has taught me about Florida. He says that is 1000% accurate.
Hey there.
Oh, really? Oh. I thought that turret was dead. I looked away and I looked back and it's left on one hit point. That is the Ryland special. Catch says the internet never lies. No, everything you read on the internet is 100% true. Actually, one of my friends was laughing the other week because his son, who's like 8 years old, I think, had said, Dad, is everything on the internet true? He had to explain some things to him. There's that heavy LRM turret.
How's it going?
Orders. Moving to position.
Catch says that would be a memorable day in that kid's life. See, we never had to contend with that, did we? I suppose the equivalent is, you know, don't believe everything you read in the newspaper for our generation. I think kids today spend a lot more time reading stuff or watching stuff on the internet than we ever did reading a newspaper. So I suppose there's a lot more potential for them absorbing horse shit. What the hell? Hotto says, if sex, drugs, and rock and roll was a state, it would be shaped like a penis and named Florida. Is that right? Ryland says, I used to think Florida was the armpit of America, but I spent Christmas in Orlando and quite enjoyed it. See you later, Catch. What's going on? Oh, they got reinforcements coming at me. All right, we got this. The LRM mechs on the front line. Never mind. Everything will be fine, I'm sure. Cold Steel says newspapers are going the way of the dinosaurs. Yeah, not surprised. Once upon a time, that was my career path, and then I changed my mind, and I'm glad of it.
Yes, Commander. On my way, double time.
Need something, Chief?
I No, they're definitely not. I mean, we could kind of see it was going that way a long time ago, like back in the late 90s, early 2000s, I suppose.
Commander?
As soon as the internet really started becoming a bigger and bigger thing, and people could just get their news for free. On the plus side, you know, it saves trees, right? Let's reserve shell for now. So Sarge says, and now, ladies and gentlemen, we bring you the wonderful world of disgusting food with Sarge. Today we talk about baked bat. I imagine it probably tastes like any other rodent. Cole still says, I just hope books hold out a while longer. Yeah. I've got a whole load of books. And you have to think, you know, by the time I hit retirement age, will they be rare commodities? You know, actual paper books.
Receiving you.
Right, what have we got? We've got an archer and a charger. Well, the charger's a joke, isn't it? Double check. Yep, it's definitely one of the joke ones. 50 armor. I mean, it's got a bunch of internals, but yeah, that armor is laughable. The archer's probably the biggest threat that I can see right now. So, with that in mind, I should make a start on that. Otto says it's all good. We communicate with pics and gifs already. Words are dead. Cross between chicken and gopher. How do you know what gopher? Don't answer that. I'm not finishing that question, Sarge. Alright, let's get Rylan into some cover.
Moving out.
This is an interesting lance.
Ready for orders.
These guys aren't going to make cover anytime soon, are they? What should I do here? He's not knocked down yet, is he? Yeah, do you know what? Let's do this. We'll go for the precision strike on the CT, knock him down at the same time, and open him up, and then maybe, just maybe, Catch will be able to finish him off.
Yes, Commander.
And that means I can afford to give him some vigilance for protection. I just have to hope they ignore who is it? Emperor Krang at the back. Right, come on, die. Yes, it's gone. Good stuff. Codeine raiding. Hello, Codeine. How are you doing? Thank you very much for the raid.
Hope we can salvage that.
Onward. No retreat.
And welcome to all of Codeine's viewers. I hope Codeine was having a good stream. Hope you were crushing mechs mercilessly under your massive metal feet. Had to restart, he says. Oh dear. Oh, thank you very much for the bit. Very kind of you.
Yes, Commander.
Right, so what am I going to do now? We've got a 65 tonner over there. I didn't pay attention to what was happening there, but I swear I heard some missiles. So they must have been coming from that 65 tonner. Okay, well, I guess first things first. We should deal with this charger that's about to get right in my face.
On the move.
That awesome's got a whole bunch of evasion, so not really much worth my while shooting at that this round. but this charger should go down relatively quickly if we just focus it with a couple of mechs. The challenge takes another victim, says Hotto. It's not an easy one, is it? Codeine says was down to two warriors and no mechs. Oh my god, that's brutal. Ouch.
Target neutralized.
Gonna have to pull Shell back a bit at some stage, I think. She's definitely getting battered at this point. Don't want to be losing that right arm, do I? Those awesomes. Triple PPCs is actually not a bad build, you know. Like obviously, we've got one on the charger that I use, that Sarge usually pilots. And it is pretty nasty. It's not just about the damage that they do, but it's also about that sensor impairment, which is kind of annoying.
Firing a full salvo.
Especially if you've been hit with all three PPCs.
Waiting for orders. Receiving you.
I'm still trying to figure out what's causing those dropped frames. It's turning various things off and seeing if it makes a difference. I mean, normally, let's do a coolant vent there. Normally, I have like Google Chrome open in the background and like my Twitch stream running in the background, stuff like that, and it doesn't have any major negative impact on the frame rate. Yeah, no, got frames again, so it's not even that. What's doing it? I've got virtually nothing going on now. I don't think there's an upload happening, because I did ask Shell if anything was going on our internet, and she said no. Weird. I mean, obviously you guys have said it's not impacting the stream, you're not noticing anything, which is great, but it's impacting my peripheral vision with little red warnings every few seconds, which is driving me nuts. I want to know what's going on.
Receiving you.
There was an update to Streamlabs OBS since I last streamed, so I don't know, maybe that's got something to do with it. Ah, Catapult A1. I like those. We do have a whole one. I wouldn't mind getting my hands on a second, maybe, though. Still, first things first, we've got an awesome to deal with. And absentmindedly, I've still got Shell on the front line. And she's not in the best condition at this point. Das ist Deutsch Infernal, sprechen Sie English bitte. I assume that was the wrong chat. Copy paste to the other chat. You're all good. Yeah, no worries, mate.
What's up, boss?
The other guy's chat is talking about food all the time. Oh my god. Wherever you go, you end up on a food channel then. Yeah. Sirian, hello, how are you doing?
Reporting.
I really need to pull Shell back and stop frontlining with a damaged mech. Also, I need to protect the right arm somehow. How am I going to do that? With great difficulty. Oh, there we go. That'll do it. How are you not dead yet, Crab? 18 hit points left on the center torso. Come on. Come on. Do you know what? I'm actually better off switching off an AC-10. No, I'm not. That won't even do it. Everything's too damn hot. How do I do? Do I chance this or? She's got high spirits. Screw it. I'm using the precision strike. I don't care. Caution to the wind. We're doing it. Just want that thing dead at this point. So now I can focus on picking apart this catapult A1 that I really want. Yeah, still not 100% Sirian, but feeling much better, thank you. Well enough to stream. Okay, so... how are we going to do this? I guess I'd quite like to take its legs off, which means, ideally, I want to try to get around the side of it.
Something cheap.
Go for a vigilance sprint. Try to get a flanking maneuver in with Emperor Krang. Inferno says, why do we want another LRM mech again? I don't use the A1s as LRM mechs, I use them as brawlers. I got my hands on one and I really like it. It's quite good fun. What did I stick in it? Like 4 SRM-6s, 2 medium lasers, and was it 2 small lasers as well? I forget now. Okay, Catch is taking the front line now. Hopefully drawing the attention of the catapult.
Waiting for orders.
Well, we have exactly the remedy for that problem, don't we, Infernal? We've got a Sarge. He says that if I had to translate it, it would go like this. You have to teach them in a painful manner not to talk about food. Just send Sarge over there. Let him join the conversation. Oh, I still can't get a line of sight to this damn mech, so I guess more sprinting and more flanking. Roger. I will get around the side of it eventually. Now what?
Waiting for orders.
Ah, yes. That's in the side arc. That's a good start. Okay.
Firing all weapons.
Infernal says, not going to complain, but I have to admit they seem annoyingly one-dimensional with heavy and assault loadouts. There are way too many LRM-based mechs. Yeah, that's just the time period, basically. That's that's just what it was in and around the 3025 period. There was a lot of reliance on those weapon systems in the heavy and assault categories. So yeah, it's just the lore, really. But as time progresses, and as you are probably aware by this point, and for those of you that aren't, time moves forward in this mod, and other mechs get released at the appropriate year, and all of that. And there's way more to come in the future. So you will see some stuff shift as time goes on, and perhaps some different loadouts and weapon systems coming in with different mechs. Aha, that's one leg gone.
Now that hit something good.
Receiving you. Moving to position.
Always need sardines, eh, Sarge?
Onward! No retreat!
Right.
Hey there.
Can Emperor Krang finally complete his flanking maneuver? It looks like he can. He can finally shoot into this other leg. There we go. It's probably not going to destroy it. Need someone else to contribute as well. Tasku says, I'll never pass MasterChef Sarge at this rate. Of course I forgot sardines.
How's it going? Move into position.
Okay, he's in pretty good condition. He can probably take this. Yeah, well, let's go for a full alpha and aim at the leg, and then I'm sure we'll get away with whatever misses. We're not going to wreck this guy in one. He's fully armored in the center torso. And the leg came off. It's all good. So we'll be able to take two pieces of salvage from that mech, which is nice. Won't be enough to finish it, but it will make a dent in the next one.
Good to go.
Oh man, why so slow?
Roger.
Moving through the dust cloud, isn't it?
Affirmative.
At least Catch managed to run around it, so he should be able to get to the objective location before anyone else.
Heading out.
So we'll just brace everyone else up, save time. And that should be mission complete. Awesome! We've done it. Yeah, it's definitely lunchtime. It's all gone revolting food again. How about just to change it up? Today you guys talk about nice food. How about that? Things that a human might want to eat voluntarily without being forced to. Syrian says, grasshopper and cricket flour tortillas with sardine ice cream. Sarge says, there you go, you get a gold star, Syrian. No, no. He gets a brown star for that. Oh wow, we already had three parts of the next A1, so we can just take a single and complete one of those. That'd be nice. What else do I want to take? I think I already completed a charge of 1L, didn't I? I was joking about sending Sarge out in it as a punishment mech. Let's check for any weapons I might want to take. Do I need another gyro? Probably not. Ah, you never know, though. Can't have too many of those. I might get one blown up at some point soon. So I guess we'll complete an archer just for something to sell in that case. So we complete a catapult A1, an archer 2R, and we're picking up a gyro. That'll do nicely. What? This is not human food. This is, Rylan says Cheerios, but with ketchup instead of milk. That's... No. Just no. Tasku says, not going to pick Stalker to make a full one. No, I picked the Archer to make a full one. I've had like a million Stalkers. I've had my fill of Stalkers. They're pretty common in this period, so you find a lot of them. Right. What do I want to do with this A1? I want to put it in storage for now. I might bring it out one day and have two of them. But not today. Right. Where to next? Let's have a look. What was even my plan? Why am I over here? Was I just aimlessly wandering about from system to system? What have I got? Let me see. So we wanted to give Cold Steel an outing in the Warhammer, but first we need to finish the Warhammer. That's going to take 8 days. So if I travel somewhere that takes me at least 8 days, that should be ready. And I want to be somewhere where I can use heavy mechs. Okay. So, a location where I can use heavy mechs. Espia, that could be the one. Pilpala could as well. An ice world would be nice, actually, because Cold Steel doesn't have coolant vent yet. Alto, thank you very much for the resub, mate. Really appreciate that. Oh, that reminds me. Have any of you seen the trailer for Warhammer Total War 2, the latest expansion? Alto linked it me yesterday. I'd already seen it because Harry had linked it me already, but this trailer is actually pretty cool. So I will link it to you guys. There you go. Check that out for the Predator homage. It's pretty awesome. If you're into that game. Right, I was trying to decide where to go. Where am I going to go? Oh, I might just go Jackamal. It's right by me. 9 days. I mean, that's almost perfect. I needed 8 days to finish that Warhammer, a three school location. Yeah, that should do it. Just fingers crossed there'll actually be some missions here. We'll see. Infernal says, I never played any of the Warhammer games. They look like rogue tech, cramped and overblown. I don't know. I like the Total War series. So, and I also, I like Warhammer stuff as well. Warhammer 40k and Warhammer. So for me, I quite like those games. They're all right. I played a lot more of the first Total Warhammer than I have of the second, but that's largely due to just being so many other games that have taken my attention away. Okay, Black Market invitation. Well, since the Black Market is completely foobar now, I'm not paying $2.5 million to not be able to buy stuff, to basically be able to look at stuff I can't afford. So I'm going to pass on that opportunity, thank you. We are no longer taking part in the black market. Now
arrived at our destination, Commander.
Let's visit the store. Yeah, it's a great trailer. It really is. Anything I want to buy here? Nope. Just a whole load of nope. Okay. Oh, just one mission here? Really? Okay. Well, that's not what I was hoping for. Okay. Well, since Altair's here, let's give him an outing. I want to use Cold Steel in this mission. Oh, the 733P is not finished yet, is it? Of course not. Okay, but we do have the Warhammer. Let's give Cold Steel a run out in the Warhammer. This is Four Skull. I don't want to be too cocky with this, do I? Maybe we'll just go with the Brawlers. Yeah, Shell's still got high spirits, so it makes sense for me to keep her in. Who else has not been on a run today? Man, loads of you. Let's give Buzzkill a go. So I've got two Sensorlock mechs there. Don't really need two Sensorlock mechs for this environment, do I? Sorry, for this makeup. We could give the Stalker a run, couldn't we? All right, so what's that? Brawler, Warhammer. Okay, so yeah, we're very brawly, and I've got to fight two Lancers, I think it said. Not that we can trust anything Darius ever says, but I've got one complete rookie pilot with just Bulwark. Yeah, this could be a challenge. Let's see. Yes, it's totally a Predator reference, Hotto. That's what makes the trailer ultra cool. Oh, God. I was going to rename it, wasn't I, Sarge? I haven't done that yet. You'll have to remind me. Otto says, I need to post a link. It's important and related to the Warhammer trailer. Okay. What is it? No, that's not how you spell permit. There you go.
Interface initiated.
Ah, it's this one. So Lance starts split into two parts. Why are my arrow keys not working all of a sudden? Oh, that's interesting. Well, that's going to make moving things around a little bit annoying. Try tabbing out and back in again. Ah, there we go. Now it's working. Just a minor bug there. Right, so enemy stuff here, and they're all in one big pile, are they? Two markers for them.
Coordinates received.
Well, I want to get my forces together first, so we'll try to converge. I've got to go at them, because I'm virtually all brawl, apart from that Warhammer who's got the large lasers.
to position.
Heading out.
Certainly.
Move order received.
Okay, what do we see? 60 tonner, 50 tonner, a six. Okay. This should be just fine. I don't think I'm going to have too many issues with those guys. Right. Let's reserve.
Reserve an action.
Orders.
Locking in coordinates. Got a sensor lock.
Commander. Roger that.
How might I help?
Yeah.
Okay. Not quite understanding that.
Awaiting orders.
Is it because the Atlas is taller? If I move the Atlas to that position, it provides some line of sight. Oh, no. It'll be down to the pilot view distance when it...
Consider it done.
Yeah. Because Cold Steel is not as highly skilled as these other guys. But he doesn't need to be if he's got Alto spotting for him. That'll provide line of sight to bring those three large lasers into play on this quick draw. So let's just go for a normal attack, because I have to remember Cold Steel has actually got really terrible gunnery skill, unlike the others. So keeping my resolve over 50% will probably be helpful for this mission. Normally you don't have to worry about it once your gunnery skill is up to a certain level, but when you're taking a rookie pilot out, or if all your pilots are rookies, you want to keep that above 50% for the bonus. Not all the time, but in a lot of cases it is helpful. I'm sure you've heard worse, Sarge.
Minimum damage. This guy's nothing. I've got something.
I did say that there's supposed to be a second lance as well, but I guess we'll have to wipe these guys out first.
Well done. Here we go.
Or at least some of them. Why is the map spun around? Okay, so what's this Osrock got? Okay. What's that at the back? 75 tons of something. Alright. So.
Receiving you.
Is Buzz killing range from where he is? He is. Awesome. I think I'm going to go for a precision strike with Buzzkill, just because he's got a huge amount of firepower. Now, do I go for the Ostrock that's got slightly better protection and is more of a threat, or do I go for the Treb? I'm going to have to go for the Treb just because it's got less evasion and less protection, but in an ideal world, I'd rather be shooting the Ostrock because it's got more firepower as I see it. The Trebuchet, at least the 5J variant of the Trebuchet, is not that scary in my opinion. Just a single LRM-15 with three medium lasers. Well, that, and it's also, it's only a medium mech compared to the Ostrock, which is a heavy, of course. Only 10 tons difference between the two, but significant enough.
Heads up, Commander. You've got contacts inbound.
Infernal says, look at this man getting greedy for punishment again. There's supposed to be more mechs, but I guess we have to make do with only these four. Well, you know, it's more fun when there's more of them. There we go. Here's the reinforcements right on cue. And they're coming in from the right flank. That could get interesting. Mm-hmm. Do I want to rush up and get the machine guns into play here? No. It's a bad idea because I don't have cooled shot. I don't even have cooled shot bonus with cold steel, let alone mastery. If I did, running up there and then drilling with those machine guns as well might have been a decent plan, but without cooled shot mastery, far too risky. I'm not going to be able to kill this thing. And then it might punch me out of the cockpit next turn. Actually, thinking about it, quick draw. I think the quick draw melee attack isn't enough to punch you out of a cockpit in one. It would take more than one punch to do it, but let's not take any chances. Not when we've got a perfectly good Atlas sitting here with two AC-20s that we can shoot at the center. There we go. That did the job.
That's a kill.
Still don't know what that 75 tonner is back there. Could be a Stalker 4P.
On the move.
Right, I'm gonna use my precision strike. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. I need to save that for next round.
Good to go.
Ah, I wish I'd used it now. That AC-20 might have hit. Never mind. Yeah, could also be an Orion Sergeant. I haven't really taken in what it shot yet. Let's try to pay attention. Yeah, I'm not sure if it shot any LRM's Infernal. I was either reading chat or not looking when it fired. Try to keep an eye on it. Oh, here it goes now. Let's see what it does. Some kind of ballistic and two large lasers. Probably a Marauder variant then.
Yes, give them everything you've got.
That's my guess anyway. Right.
Commander.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, buzzkill with the precision strike again. This guy's got a bunch of damage mitigation here, but buzzkill's got a huge amount of damage that he can output. Mitigate that.
Target neutralized.
Yeah, I think the quick draw's just got a particularly weak melee attack, if I remember rightly. I'll have to have a look in a bit after this mission, but I think it's 60 or below. Obviously, anything 61 or above is scary. What's that? Completely unknown at this point. Let's just brace up.
Yes, Commander.
Yeah, I might go for a vigilance sprint here with Shell, because I want to see what that is. And get close enough to attack it. So it is a Marauder, and it's the Marauder 3M.
They've got a lock on me.
So, yeah, replacing PPCs with large lasers, as you can see there. Two large lasers, two mediums, and an AC-5. I believe that's the Marek variant of the Marauder. And there it is, in its Marek colours. Looking hideous.
Yes, Commander.
What are we going to do with Alto? Sprinting doesn't really get me very far, does it? Well, I need to be careful that that Marauder doesn't get line of sight and start shooting into the backs of these two mechs. But he's pretty far away, and he's got other things to worry about right now. Saying that,
onward.
He did have a crack at shooting cold steel in the back there. That was a little bit concerning. Obviously, he missed, so it's all fine, but that could have been bad. I'm just angling like this just in case something sensor locks and shoots missiles from this direction, but... Tasku, thank you very much for the follow. Do I have a Marauder 3M in the collection? Does anyone remember if we have one of these already or not? I can't remember, so let's play it safe and try shooting its legs off. 34%, really? Oh, I still don't have Cool Shot Mastery with Shell, do I? Oh, it's not even worth it, is it? Oh well, we'll just trash this whatever way. I'm sure we'll find another in the future. Hey, HPFT, thank you. How are you doing?
Reporting heavy damage.
Yeah, it gets confusing for me between my stream career and my non-stream career, which mechs I've collected in which career. So I'm pretty sure on my non-stream career I've got all of the Marauder variants by this point, or most of them. I think I'm pretty sure I've got a 3M on that one anyhow. But I'm not sure if I've got one on this as well or not. Okay, definitely need to be careful about how I'm angling because that Marauder's still not down. What have we got here? Ah, Bombardier! Awesome. Well, I mean, I say awesome. I like to own Bombardiers. I don't particularly like being shot with twin LRM-20s. Oh, man, this is... I've got the wrong pilots here. There's two mechs that I want to salvage, and I don't have the Cool Shot Masteries to do it. Never mind. All right, we'll go with some Vigilance on Cold Steel, since he's going to be front-lining against three, possibly four mechs over here. So he'll want some protection. And then we'll start burning down that Bombardier. HBFD says been having Doyle withdrawals. Oh, thank you.
Sensor locked.
Oh god. Oh no. Breaching shot as well. That looks like it's not as many missiles as I thought it was gonna be. That had me worried. There is a fourth mech. Okay. Okay. Yeah. This is a lance of LRM beasts. Then.
What's the plan?
Alto, get stuck in. You're gonna have to do all the killing over here while you're accompanying this rookie in a Warhammer. What should I do? Should I try? Should I try for the lucky headshot? Is it time for an attempt at a lucky headshot? Are we feeling lucky today, chat? I'm not feeling very lucky, to be honest. Ah, let's try it. Why not?
Confirm.
Didn't look like we got it. No, we didn't get it that time.
Reporting. Critical hit.
Onward. No retreat.
Oh, guys, you'll never guess what I discovered while I was ill and not able to stream. I was playing some of my non-stream career on this game, and I found another Night Star. So I didn't manage to salvage a whole one, but I found another Night Star. But it wasn't the same Night Star that we're hunting for in the stream career. This was another variant. This showed up, I think it was for House Marek. I think it had a J in its... title, because the one we're looking for from the Federated Suns is the 10C, I think, and the one I saw was a different designation. Was it a 7J, something like that? I don't know. We need the Sargipedia for this. But yeah, I saw another Night Star, but the wrong type of Night Star and on the wrong saved game. So, you know, that's just how it goes, right? This is already looking like quite a scary support lance. I guess we keep whittling down this Bombardier. It'd be nice if I could knock that LRM-20 off. Let's go for some more Vigilance. because he's going to take another round of getting smashed. But we do have an Atlas accompanying him. Wow, that shooting. Oh, my God. Oh, dear. Cold steel. That was the worst shooting I've seen in a long time. Poor guy's only got gunnery 4. He needs the experience.
Ready for orders.
But he's not going to get it if we don't take him on missions, is he? All right, I need to just wreck this, I suppose. Still want to take the legs if I can, really.
I think I hit something good.
Yeah, so there are two variants of the Night Star, Harry says. So I've seen both variants now.
I'm under heavy fire.
And as I said, I'm pretty sure the other variant, so we've seen the one that showed up for Davian, but the other variant I think showed up for House Marek. Pretty sure I was fighting Marek when it appeared. Oh, this is not enough cool chop mastery. 30% on this leg. Oh, is that, that's just not happening, is it? 30%. I think I might switch off the AC-20. And we'll go with the missiles. How's this going to work? Is it going to work? No, it's not going to work. Never mind. Oh, well. More breaching shot. No 60% damage reduction for cold steel if they're just going to use breaching shot, eh? Okay. It's time for Alto to take the front line, I think.
Of course.
What do we see there? A quick draw, an archer. Okay. Rifleman and the bombardier. So, a couple of mechs that are LRM beasts. And then a quick draw. And the rifleman, still, in my opinion, the scariest 60 tonner around. Okay, well, I guess we shoot up the bombardier. That's one LRM-20 down. Still pretty scary with a single LRM-20, especially in light of the fact this guy's got breaching shot, so it doesn't really bother him to lose one, I suppose. Structure exposed on cold steel. Oh dear. Oh dear.
Good to go.
What is it? Oh, it's just an arm with a plus large laser in, but still. Which arm is that? The right arm. Yeah, I could angle like that, but I need to... I can't shoot at the bombardier if I do, but I need to pull him back behind the Atlas, and the only way I'm going to achieve that is to move him to here. So I guess I'm just going to have to deal with not being able to shoot the bombardier. That's fine. Preservation is more important. Right, so choice of quick draw or rifleman. I'm definitely going to go for the rifleman, not only because I can get the extra medium laser in, but also because the rifleman's a lot more scary than the quick draw. Although that being said, the rifleman's capped out for heat almost at the moment, but yeah, I'd still rather start work on this. Two large lasers, two AC-5s, two medium lasers. Very scary loadout for a 60-ton mech. That's what we wanted. A shooting Alto now. It's all good. Hide, if in doubt, hide behind the Atlas.
What's up, boss?
Right. Oh, yeah. I've just finished accidentally obliterating that. So let's sprint and try to get involved in this fight over here before it's too late. 9J. That's it. Thank you, Sargepedia. Okay, apparently the bombardier is still interested in smashing up Cold Steel. He's doing all right. He's doing okay. I mean, only 18 hit points left on that arm, but could be a lot worse.
Awaiting order.
Right. How can they fail to shoot this Atlas now? It's right in their faces. What am I going to do? I just need to straight up kill stuff, really. So the Bombardier has now run himself out of LRM 20 ammo. That's one thing with the Bombardiers. They don't carry a lot of ammo. So we destroyed one LRM 20, and the other one he's actually run himself out of ammo with. Also, he seems to be out of SRM ammo as well. Just armed with a machine gun and his ability to punch, kick, or headbutt. So I might just ignore him right now with Alto in favor of doing a precision strike on the CT of this archer. So the archer's a big threat still. So let's chance that. I doubt I'll kill it. But it'll certainly have made a good start. That looked pretty decent to me. Let's see what he's left with. 27 hit points left in the center torso. Nice. Right, let's get Shell out of the woods. Trying to sprint to catch up. These two mechs over here are going to have a hard time catching up. This fight will be half over. Oh no! Oh no! Stop shooting at Cold Steel. He's too new to die. What's this quick draw doing? Shoot the Atlas, damn it. It's a perfectly good Atlas. There you go. That's what we want. Okay.
Standing by. Yes, Commander.
I think we need to keep backing Cold Steel away. I'm going to keep him angled like this, keep protecting that right arm. Now, I want to shoot at the archer. Three large lasers. I'm hoping for just some blind luck that I might hit the center torso. Oh, I'm not even going to be able to fire three, am I? Because he's too hot. Okay, two large lasers and relying on blind luck to hit that center torso. It's pretty unlikely to happen. But we may as well give it a try, right? We didn't lose anything for trying. Well, what's this bombardier going to do? Stand menacingly behind my Atlas. Kind of concerning, but never mind. It's all right. The Stalker's almost there. He's going to save the day. Archer choosing not to shoot this time, instead deciding to protect his very vulnerable center torso. Okay, this I am fine with, but I could really do with finishing it off all the same. Can't actually get in. Yeah, I can't get an angle on the front of him anymore, thanks to his positioning. Well done, AI. So, I guess instead, I'm going to have to take out this bombardier.
As you wish.
And I suppose with him being right up in my face as well, it makes sense.
Yes, Commander.
Before he starts punching people out of cockpits. I can't actually remember what the melee attack of a bombardier is. I know an archer, which is a similar kind of mech, an archer can punch you for... Is it 100 damage? I think it's something stupidly high. So maybe a bombardier can punch almost as hard.
Onward! No retreat!
Yes, that's right, Tasku. It is improved AI, and there are some tweaks to lance compositions and things like that as well, and some tweaks to how brawlers behave too. So, I mean, it's not perfect. No game AI ever is, but it's certainly a lot better than the vanilla AI. Choosing to shut down there. Okay. I guess they really want to smash up Cold Steel, don't they? Right. Let's start from the back. Let's get the Stalker involved first, because there's a shutdown quick draw that is just asking for this. You asked for this quick draw. This is of your own making. Don't shut yourself down in front of a Stalker, you idiot. Look at that.
Tango down.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, thanks. Syrian's reminded me as well. Yeah, there's a slight nerf to Cold Shot Mastery. So normal Cold Shot and Cold Shot Bonus are unchanged, but Cold Shot Mastery, you've got slightly reduced percentage to hit. So whereas in vanilla, a headshot would from the front would be an 18% chance, in this mod, it's a 15% chance instead. So headshots don't happen anywhere near as much. It doesn't sound like a huge reduction, but actually makes a significant enough difference that it changed my strategy up in terms of how often I go for headshots and how I build my mechs as well for that.
I understand.
Previously, I'd go for quite a few headshots and you'd get, you know, maximum salvage from killing mechs that way quite often. Now, it's quite a rare thing for me to try for a headshot even. Keep backing away, Cold Steel. It's not safe for you here.
Moving out.
Oh, he's not shut down. Okay. I would really quite like to get lucky enough to hit that center torso, please. That would be great. No, not happening, is it? That archer is living on borrowed time. Really should have died by now.
Yes, give them everything you've got.
Waiting for orders.
Aha, can get into the front arc there. That'll do nicely. Firm. This Stalker, man. This is the most brawl damage of anything that I think is practical that I've ever built. It even beat my old Stalker 3F. It's not as pinpoint accurate because you're replacing, well, I mean, the 3F was 6 medium lasers and 4 SRM6s, whereas this is 6 SRM6s and 4 medium lasers. So, sorry, 2 medium lasers, my bad. So, yeah, you're swapping precision with the lasers for just damage spam with the SRM6s, but boy, is it fun to use. It's a lot of fun, just seeing that cloud of missiles evaporate mechs. Okay, we're going to go for a precision strike with Cold Steel. Unlikely to pull this off, but we're going to try anyway. 9%. We've got 9% on the center torso. Can he do it? Can he be the hero and finish this mission in style with a 9% center torso hit with 2 large lasers? Crunch those numbers. This is not happening. Not happening. He did get the right torso. Oh, no, he done it. He's actually done it. Was that just from the damage of blowing the right torso off, though? I've got a feeling it might have been.
Successful.
But we'll take it. We'll take it. Good stuff from Cold Steel there. And that'll earn him some valuable experience. Hopefully we can improve that gunnery skill. Oh, Tasku's asking, how much is the alpha on that SRM barrage? I believe it's 502 damage, something like that. And my previous highest was 498, I think, on the Stalker 3F. That was one of the first things I built when I first got my hands on a Stalker in this game. Just filled it with medium lasers and SRMs. I was like, yep, that's brutal. And I couldn't find a practical heat-efficient build that was more damage than that. I did mention before, I saw someone yoinked it not too long after I first showed it on stream. And was like, oh yes, have you seen my build that I came up with? That, like, almost exactly using my words and my build. I was like, oh really, that's your build you came up with, is it? Of course, it could have been coincidence, but the language used sounded like he'd seen my stream. And then gone, oh, hey guys, look what I've come up with all on my own, all myself. This is mine. I didn't steal it from anywhere. I was like, okay. Obviously, I didn't bother writing anything on Reddit. Just saw it and went, all right, okay. Yes, rename the Warhammer, says Sarge. We will do that. And also, we'll have a double check on that Stalker to confirm the damage. I also want to see what the melee damage of a quick draw is as well. HBFT says, I come up with nothing on my own. I rely on the chat generals. There's no shame in that, HBFT. Nothing wrong with that. There's a lot of people that know a lot of stuff about Battletech. Oh, I do like the Bombardier. As you can see, I've already got one there. I just really like the heavy mechs that I can turn into SRM boats. And you've got 5 missile slots on a Bombardier, which makes me happy. Right, so let's get the repairs done on the Warhammer and at the same time rename it. And we're good. Yeah, we're all good. Right, I'll look at the melee damage on a quick draw. Hopefully I'll be able to see without needing to bring it out. Oh yeah. Oh, I do have a Marauder 3M as well. So I've got... So I haven't got a complete 3L and I haven't got a complete 3D, but I do have the 3M. Alright, that's something to try to remember. Right, brawl damage on things. Alright, what's the brawl damage on the Bombardier? Oh, it's not going to tell me the number, is it? It's just going to show me a bar. That's annoying. I wanted to see the precise number for the quick draws. But, well, whatever it is, it's less than a Bombardier. Doesn't really tell me much. Less than an Ossol as well. Less than a dragon. Well, based on that, I'm going to guess that it's probably, I don't know, somewhere between 50 and 70. That's quite a big margin of error there for the guess, but I don't know. So I'm sure someone will luck it up at some point. Right, let's go sort out some pilot XP because we've just done a mission with Cold Steel and I'm sure he'll be able to level something up.
To go.
Right. Oh yeah, of course. I want to get him coolant vent. That's why he's so low on gunnery at the moment, because I'm saving up for coolant vent first, because that makes him instantly useful in a lot of the hot environments. Yeah, so I'll save up for that. I'll get coolant vent and then I'll go up the gunnery tree, I think. Right, any more contracts here? Nope. What a nice 3 skull location, or 3.5. I wanna take my heavy mechs out for a proper spin. Is there nowhere a three skull around me? What? What is this? What's with all these 2.5s? I don't want 2.5s. Ah, there we go. We could go there. Well, that's quite a long hop, but... yeah, let's do it. Just want an excuse to take my heavy lance out on a mission. Maybe if there's something lower, take the mediums out as well. Emperor Krang, hello. He says, not quite as handsome as my character is.
That work order you submitted is complete.
What was that work order? Was that the Highlander 733P? I don't know, it might have been the repair on the Warhammer, wasn't it? Yeah, that was it. While that's happening, let's put that down, see if that makes a difference with the frames. Sirian says, gotta go shovel some snow, have a great rest of stream, catch the VOD later. No worries, thank you very much. And I'm sorry you've got to shovel snow. That sucks, man. In April. Tasku says, what would you say if there would be an option for Mech Bay 4? Yeah, I think I'm with HBFT there. He says, yes, please, and goodbye to my sea bills for monthly upkeep. Yeah, I'd probably be the same. If I could have more mechs out and ready, I probably would. And somehow I would find a way to afford it.
Ready to go over financials whenever you are.
Yeah, look at those monthly costs. They're not exactly low, are they? Right, 4 days away from our destination. All right, what's going on here? What is going on here? Cold Steel and Sarge are having an argument. Actually, I think this one's worth reading out. So, raised voices echo down the barracks hallway and you arrive to find Cold Steel facing off with Sarge. That's just not how it's done. We're mercenaries. We go where the money is, Cold Steel sneers. Why the hell did we face that Steiner kill team for 0 C-bills? We didn't owe anything to Gwydion Company. Sarge suddenly erupts. My cousin is in the Gwydion Company. He's alive because of the commander and a better mech warrior than you'll ever be. He stalks from the barracks. In the silence that follows, the room finally notices that you've arrived. Okay. How are we going to deal with this? Summon both to your quarters. I think that's the plan. Okay, so they both have low spirits now. Great. When the mech warriors arrive at your quarters and see the look on your face, they both look nervous. I don't care if you disagree with my orders, as long as you follow them. We're in a dangerous business. On the battlefield, you will have each other's back. Is that clear? Sir, yes, sir, they shout in unison, eyes fixed on a spot on the wall past your shoulder. You look both of them in the eyes, and you will keep your mouth shut about any misgivings in front of your fellow mech warriors. If you undermine my authority one more time, I'll ship you planetside. You pause for effect. Or better yet, I'll put you in a spider on the next contract. Only a spider? Come on! We've got worse mechs than spiders we could throw them out in. How about a charger? So yeah, they both get low spirits for that. Clearly I made the wrong choice. I should have just bollocked one of them, but I didn't want to show favoritism. That's hardly fair, is it? You know, just talk to them both. That should have been the right decision. Apparently the game disagrees. Oh well. Ryland says, we can't forget that mercenaries are human. Respect my authority, says HPFT. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, I don't remember seeing that one before, so I thought it was worth reading out. As I've said before, I don't read a lot of those out because we've all seen them so many times. It's just you know, not really worth reading out. But when I encounter a new one or one I don't recognize, I think it's worth. Yeah, you see, I'm with Infernal. Throw them in a cicada. That's way worse punishment than a spider. I think a spider has more armor. Okay, what have we got here? 2 3.5 skull locations. One is a base destruction in the Badlands. The other is a polar battle. Actually, that's quite a big payout for that 3.5 skull. That could be quite a nasty mission. Still, I'm gonna try this with the heavies. Let's up it to 3 bits of salvage. And we're fighting for the Magistracy of Canopus. Or the Magicians of Cannabis. Right, well, now this kind of scuppers the whole plan. No, it doesn't. It doesn't, because I was never going to use any resolve on Cold Steel anyway. Apart from maybe Vigilance. I suppose I can live without that. But I was going to say that low spirits could be a problem, because I wanted to bring out the heavies so that I can use Cold Steel, get him some more experience. I think it's worth it anyhow. I think we'll be just fine. Right, let's get Black Cat in as well. It's a rare opportunity. Polar environment. Make the use of him and his lack of coolant vent. Who else should I use? Who's not been out today? Well, Emperor Krang only just showed up, so he's not seen himself be used, even though I used him earlier on. So we'll give him a run. And... I think I might take Sarge. So let's swap Shell out, Sarge in. And again, I know you might be looking at this going, why? He's got low spirits, you idiot. Why are you taking Sarge? Well, it's just because in the Heavy Lance... I've got the Thug, and Sarge is a big fan of the Thug. And I know the Thug is an assault mech at 80 tons. It's not heavy. I am aware of this. But it may as well be. It's not far off. So we're going to squeeze that in. Right. So what have we got? We've got Emperor Krang in the Wreck-It Ryland Catapult A1. Cold Steel in the Steel Hammer. Black Cat in the Bombardier. And Sarge in the Devil Dog Mark II. That should work fine, I think. So this could be a challenge, because, you know, it could be slightly tricky for this loadout, because I'm very brawly. I can't really play long range and kite and reduce the incoming damage with a brawly lance like this. But we'll make do. And you never know with a 3.5. I mean, sometimes the 3.5 skulls can be really easy. Sometimes you can be facing assault mechs. It's just you don't know what you're going to get, really. But I saw the payout was quite high, so that made me a little bit concerned it might be on the tricky side. But we'll have to wait and see. Tasky says, give him the spider. I should have. Or the punishment charger. That was something I was going to bring out for Sarge at some point. I haven't got around to it. Again, I need those extra 4 mech bay slots, don't I? That's what I need. Then I'll have room for messing about mechs as well. HVFT says, trooper, no armor, all ammo. Nice. I don't think I've got a complete one of those. I definitely got some bits, maybe one bit, because I probably evaporated the only one I encountered. Tasku says maybe the summer DLC will give us Mech Bay 4. I doubt it. I don't think they're going to give us any more. I wouldn't complain if the option was there, though.
I get to choose between hellfire or a frozen death.
Okay.
Copy that.
Heading out. Acknowledged.
I don't mind this map. Ah, vehicle. Okay. There are still vehicles we haven't seen. Obviously, the last update introduced a whole bunch. So maybe we'll see some new stuff. What are you? Oh, it's a laser carrier. Okay. Well, I mean, certainly not to be scoffed at. Those laser carriers are pretty nasty. Especially considering, unlike the laser boat Hunchback 4P that has heat to contend with, the vehicles don't. So that can just keep on firing all eight of those medium lasers over and over. Pretty scary prospect, to be honest. I'm just going to try to wipe that out immediately with Sarge. See if we can pull it off.
Sweet.
Please be lucky. Yeah, that's done it. Yes, done it. Awesome. Okay, so it didn't get to shoot at us, which is nice. I did notice there's a 100-ton vehicle back there. And something up here, that's an 80-tonner. Yeah, that's right, HBFT. So the vehicles don't have any heat build up. Obviously the mechs do. But that's one of the things that makes vehicles quite nasty and worth taking out early on if you can.
What's up, boss?
Right. So the first mech appears. But we can't shoot at that. Oh, it's a Stalker 4P. Of course it is. But we can shoot at the behemoth. And boy, do we want to get rid of this thing. Look at all those weapons. That is a big old list of guns. So Emperor Krang is worth using resolve with because he's not got low spirits, unlike Cold Steel and Sarge. And he does have Cool Shot Mastery as well. So we're going to fire everything at the side of the behemoth and hope for the best. Probably not going to kill it, but if we can open it up. Yeah, nice. 18 hit points remaining. Yeah, if we can open it up and then maybe get a lucky hit with Cold Steel, let's try. See if one of those large lasers can clip that side. No. That first laser shot, he was just, you know, getting his eye in. Just testing the range. It was pretty wildly off target, wasn't it? What to do here with Black Cat? Do you know what? I might go for a vigilance move here and then try my luck at firing a cloud of SRMs at that behemoth. If I can kill this thing before it gets to shoot, that would be fantastic. Now, do I just rely on the luck of having a huge pile of missiles here and only needing to do 18 damage to that side? Or do I do a precision strike? I think I need to save the resolve, so... Alright, we'll chance it. We'll chance it. Fingers crossed this doesn't go badly wrong. Come on, just hit that side. Yes, he's done it. That will do. So, another vehicle wiped out before we get to... before it gets to shoot. And Sarge can start picking on this Hunchback 4P. And for those of you that might not have seen the Thug before, oh, there it is. If you play MWO, you'll recognize it as something else, but yeah, that is the Thug in Battletech. Quite a decent, fast 80-ton mech, but not as much fun, in my opinion, as the Charger SB. I really like that. Ooh, what am I doing? No precision strike for Sarge. We'll just fire randomly with the four large lasers. Sarge says boxing match results between Sarge and Cold Steel. As they go to touch gloves, Sarge sucker punches Cold in the balls. Bending down to Cold Steel, I remind him that in a fight, anything's fair. Sarge wins by default.
Waiting for
Right. He's got a lot of evasion now. That's barely even worth shooting at, is it?
What's up, boss?
I really don't know what to do right now. I'm a little bit worried about this 80-tonner back there. Don't want to expose the backs of these brawlers, you see. I guess I'll just do this. Just step him into the cover. Just try to keep the back angled carefully so that vehicle doesn't get around it. And yeah, I'm well aware that I have very low chances of hitting here, but I do have a lot of missiles. So my options here, I could go for the sensor lock, take two evasion pips off him and make him easier to hit for the rest. But at 40%, 145, I think it's probably worth firing my SRMs because some stuff's going to connect. And in this environment, it's not as if I'm building up heat, really, with that loadout. Right.
Orders.
Let's get cold steel on the job. Again, not great chances to hit, but I'm pretty sure that that guy's not going to have all that evasion next turn. He's probably going to stand and shoot. I'm getting a head start on damage. Would be nice. Now, where's that coming from?
Picking up a new sensor trace. Looks like enemy
reinforcement. Okay, just reinforcement mechs. I say breaching shot. Damn. So much breaching shot on the enemy recently.
Ready for orders.
Not really sure what to do here. All right, let's try that. I'm going to go for vigilance. Again, I'm trying to be careful about where my back's facing in light of that guy being over there. Now we've got some good chances to hit. That'll do. Still got a large amount of damage mitigation, 40% there. So it's going to take a lot more than that to knock something off him. But it's a start. So I'm going
to
reposition Sarge because I'm getting worried about that vehicle. So I want to get him... at least making a start on it. What is it? It's an AC carrier. All right. I mean, that could have been a lot scarier. It could have been any kind of demolisher, devastator type dual AC-20 thing. So we'll take this. Still would rather kill it than have it shooting my mechs in the back, though. Bombardier pilot Black Cat there is the only pilot, I think. Well, apart from newly signed Cold Steel. No, Cold Steel's got Bulwark already. Yeah, I think Black Cat's the only pilot I have that doesn't have Bulwark.
Reporting. Heavy damage. Oh, Commander. I'm hit.
Sarge takes one in the head. Cheeky little vehicle's got ace pilot as well, so he's buggered off after doing that too. What are we gonna do here? Well, this is awkward.
Waiting for orders.
And very risky, but
on the move.
We're risking it. Don't like leaving my pilots within melee range ordinarily, but it was either use more resolve on being out of cover or move into cover and go for a precision strike, strip this guy.
Receiving you.
Hmm.
Make them dead.
Now, in an ideal world, I want to basically be finishing that guy if I can this turn. Just, like I said, to make sure he doesn't get an opportunity to punch Emperor Krang out of his cockpit. But it might be a tall order. We'll have to see.
Acknowledged.
What's your cold shot ability? No, awful, awful, awful. Let's just fire a cloud of missiles. If we can leave him open, I might be able to finish it off with Sarge. I know it'll cost me extra resolve to do a precision strike with Sarge, but it'll be worth it if I kill that target and just completely eliminate the potential melee threat. So what's he left with? Ugh. Probably not going to manage that, am I? We'll try it.
Time to unload.
Yeah. So three of those managed to hit the CT. Even if the fourth had done it, I'd still have been 7 hit points short of finishing it off. Never mind.
Systems holding.
Well, luckily, it didn't go for a melee attack, so we got away with that. We'll take it. Awesome. Finally, I get the Warhammer machine guns into play on the steel hammer. That's what I want. 4 machine guns. Okay, so we've got a fairly good chance of pulling this off. So we'll try our luck. And I've got plenty of other mechs to play with if someone else needs to finish the job. But I think we've killed this Stalker. There he goes.
Tangled down.
Yeah, not the smartest move that Stalker ever made, was it, Tasku? Okay, we've still got that vehicle to worry about. And I do want to pull Black Cat out of trouble now. Hold on. Go for a sensor lock. Then move. There.
Position confirmed.
He's got ace pilot, you see, and sensor lock. Right. I want Emperor Krang to be my new front line for when the reinforcements show up. So we're going to push him forward. Just because he's better at mitigating damage than Black Cat is. And Sarge needs to deal with this tank. Looks like that's the only spot that I can do it from, so there we'll have to do. Ah, this should be easy. Come on, just got to hit him in the front once. There we go. Vehicle destroyed. So, now we're just worrying about reinforcements.
Vehicle destroyed.
That's right, Tasku. Yep, they're intravenous vodka bags when Sarge is talking about them. Oh, he says 3/4 medicine, 1/4 vodka. I'm not sure I believe that.
Good to go. Orders?
Let's sprint Black Cat over to here. Look at all that lovely evasion he's got. I'll have a hard time hitting him, even if they do spot him. Oh, they've sensor locked him. Well, that reduces evasion a bit. Oh well. Well, still, that served its purpose. I wanted to move him first because I was hoping something, not necessarily that, but something would move into range of Emperor Krang in the meantime, and it has. I can't get into cover and shoot, but I can move here, use vigilance to give myself some protection, and shoot. Which, in my opinion, is better than not shooting at all.
Firing.
Especially when you do that amount of damage. He's not having a good day, is he, that quick draw? So what's behind? 75 and an 85 ton mech. Okay. Cold steel, where are we going to go with you? Let's move towards these trees, I think. So thanks to the long range of those large lasers, he can contribute to the fight. Not bad chances to hit as well. Managed to land all three shots as well. And open something up on that quick draw. What was it? Center opened up. Really nice job. Right. Sarge can't contribute from where he is, unfortunately, so we're just going to have to reposition him completely. And this is where the speed of this mech comes in handy. For an assault mech, it can move. Look at that. It's gone a long way. And a good opportunity to lose some heat as well. Well, something's got a lot of missiles.
Light damage, Commander.
I'm guessing that's a Stalker. That one. And I'm not sure what that is. It could have been an Awesome. Oh, no, it can't be an Awesome. Awesomes are 80 tons. So either a Stalker or a longbow. It didn't seem like enough missiles to be a longbow. Still, I'm sure we'll find out shortly. I'm going to continue the advance with Emperor Krang. We'll get him into the trees this time. We'll give him vigilance for even more protection since he's facing down all these mechs. So, yeah, Stalkers. Two Stalkers there. And the quick draw here. So we're going to shoot the quick draw because he's already opened center torso. We may as well finish what we started. He's not down yet, but it would be nice if we do manage to finish that quick draw in time to get at least a volley into that Stalker 4P while he's out in the open and has no cover. But we'll have to see. All right, Black Hat can get in range, only just really. It's pretty extreme range for the SRMs, but only need 20 more damage to the center of that quick draw to finish him off, and I would hope that that is well within the capabilities of five SRM-6s. There he goes. Okay, so that leaves two mechs now, potentially, to have a pop at this guy with.
Commander.
Alright, cold steel. Can't get an angle from inside of cover, so I guess we'll step out of cover. At the moment, I think he's all right. I don't think the enemy has line of sight to him, so I can afford to just sit out of cover like this when I'm this far back. Just make use of those large lasers. And of course, on top of the three that Cold Steel has, Sarge has four of his own. But yeah, we only got to fire that one volley of three at the Stalker before he moved into cover. Never mind. Well, we're almost max for resolve, so although it's going to cost me a lot to use this on Sarge, he's the last mech to go this round for me before the resolve gets replenished, so I may as well use it. We'll go for a precision strike on the center here. So it's going to take us quite a bit to wear down that Stalker, even if it is a 75-ton one. Another stalker. Hey, Infernal, where are you? I think he's gone now. He hates how many stalkers there are in this.
Receiving you.
But it's just law. It's law compliant. It's just the times, man.
Roger.
But yeah, so we've got three different stalkers, though. We've got the 75-ton Stalker 4P. And the Stalker 4N, which is 85, and also 85 tons, the Stalker 3H. And this is the scary one, in my opinion, with the two LRM-20s, two SRM-6s, and four medium lasers. That one is the one I fear the most. But we've started work on this Stalker 4P, so we're going to continue. Must remember to do vigilance first, though, because this guy, Emperor Krang, is going to take so much punishment from these three mechs being on the front line. And there's no reprieve for him in sight since he's so far ahead of the rest of my mechs. So he's just going to have to take it.
Ready for orders.
Okay, risky time with Black Cat, I suppose. This is. I want to shoot, though. So, again, I'm going to give him vigilance because he's out in the open, but lacking bulwark, he only gets 20% damage mitigation from vigilance. Does old Black Hat, but I wanted to shoot. I want to keep this barrage going on this Stalker 4P. If possible, it would be nice to be able to kill him this turn between my four mechs.
Solid connection on that one.
Just, you know, one way of giving Emperor Krang more protection on the front line is to make less enemies able to shoot him by killing them.
Heads out.
So what's he got left now? 50. Okay. So we're not going to manage it with cold steel, or at least it's unlikely. Maybe if we get lucky and Sarge hits that center as well, we might pull off the kill. So he should be down to 20 hit points in the CT now.
Got a lock on me.
Yeah, so he's on 20, and Sarge has got four large lasers to play with here.
On the move.
So again, there's a lot of locations he could hit, but we just need one to hit the center. Come on, Sarge. Hard to say. Yeah, apparently he did it. I was going to say, it's hard to say if any where those hit, because all I can see is trees, but yep, Sarge did the job. Nice. So just two stalkers left. Well, I say just two stalkers. It's still pretty scary. It's a lot of firepower, and it's all being pounded into Emperor Krang still.
I'm gonna need
him. Oh, and a headshot as well, just, you know, because he hadn't got enough problems already. He's wearing it well, though. Look at that. That's pretty good. Spread of damage, nothing getting too bashed up ahead of anything else, and we have been giving him vigilance every turn, and we're going to continue doing that. Actually managed to get the small lasers into play there by the looks of things. Vigilance again, and you know what, I might actually go for a precision strike here. We're going to go for a coolant vent so I can afford to fire everything with this precision strike. But yeah, should I try for the headshot? Should I just play it simple? Nah, we'll go for simple. We'll open up the CT, in theory, maybe. We'll try to, anyway. Did I see that correctly? Yeah, my small lasers, I think, are doing more damage than my medium lasers right now. I could do with getting some more plus 10 damage medium lasers.
Affirmative.
But yeah, how have we left it? Oh, 45 armor remaining. Possible. Yeah, I guess we'll keep working on him. But it's tempting to shoot this guy because he's completely out of cover and he's the scarier of the stalkers, but I went for this one just because I got those two extra small lasers into range by shooting the catapult at this one, and that's 60 damage, because I mean these two small lasers are 30 damage small lasers. So obviously after 20% damage reduction, it's less than 60, but it's still, you know, it's a lot of damage all the same. I just felt it was worth my while.
Waiting for orders. On the move. Confirmed. They've got a sensor lock on me. Standing by. Heading out.
Okay. Oh, he's running away now. I think it's just worth keeping that barrage of fire on him. Although he's showing his left side now. We've almost actually popped that off. Is that enough to make it fall off? It is. Left torso gone. Okay, so that's reduced quite a lot of potential firepower. That was worth it. Oh, crap. No, not Black Cat. Please, not Black Cat. He's not built to take this. Why are you shooting Black Cat anyway? You've got a perfectly good Krang right in front of you. What is that all about? Alright, now what? Oh, God. Do you know what? It's really tempting to do this. Because that's the fresh one. That's the fresh one, and I can shoot him in the back. Look. I mean, how can I not do this right now? I've got to do this. It's too much of an opportunity to pass up. It's another risky maneuver for Emperor Krang, but come on. Oh no, he's not done it. It's got to be close, right? Oh, would you look at that? Would you look at that? One hit point remaining. One hit point. Oh man. He was so nearly the hero. Still, you had to give that a try. That is just needed to be done. Right, so now really I've got to keep focusing down this stalker, try to get it killed so that it doesn't run in and melee Emperor Krang. Okay, good, he's down. CT destroyed. Good job, Black Cat. Right, now we can focus everyone else on this guy. And oh man, I've got to do 180 points of armor through the front now, though, which is really, really annoying. I think I can get the medium laser in range by moving here. Yep, that works out. Spit on him, Krang, says Sarge. I know, tell me about it. Just flick a bogey at him or something. Anything. All right, we don't have any resolve for precision striking here, so we're just going to have to just spam damage. Okay, well that worked. We'll take that. I'm kind of happy that he decided to shoot at Cold Steel rather than hopping around the back arc of Emperor Krang and blowing him away. I'm all good with this.
Waiting for orders. I copy.
Well, I'm pretty sure this is going to be finished by Emperor Krang into the rear of this stalker for the second time, because that maneuver by the AI right there was possibly the dumbest thing I've seen it do all day. Now, Emperor Krang is running hot now, so we'll have to switch some weapons off, but whatever. There we go. 3 SRM6s, 2 small lasers. Should be enough, right? And we'll go for a precision strike as well. Just, you know, because why not? This is the last mech standing. He has one hit point remaining on the rear center torso.
Got the angle.
May as well use the resolve. Because that's the mission over.
Now the gloves are off.
There we go. Job done. Cold Steel says, I can take it, boss. No worries. And some more valuable XP earned for newbie Cold Steel. As I said, I want to get that coolant vent on him before I start giving him more gunnery skill, but I'm looking forward to him having more gunnery skill, to be honest. So he's not doing too badly with those three large lasers, at least. You know, he's got reasonable hit chances. Right, so Sarge injured for 6 days, Black Cat out for 10 days, Emperor Krang out for 6 days, and Cold Steel completely uninjured. What am I even going to take from this? I don't want or need more Stalkers. Oh, I do want and need these, though. We'll take the plus 10 damage, plus 3 accuracy, large laser. Yes, please. Any plus damage medium lasers? Come on. Yes. Yep, we'll take that. And anything else? Nope. Okay, well, I guess we'll finish off a Stalker. Gives us something to sell. And still forever waiting for the plus damage AC-10s to show up. Rylan says, do I still have the most injuries? I think you do. Yeah, just. You're just ahead of Catch. Hey, Samurai, how you doing? I'm not dead.
That mech you wanted is back online.
HBFT says, I almost bankrupted myself getting a plus 10 damage AC-10 because of your recommendation. It is glorious. Yeah, I love him. I think possibly my favorite weapon in the game. I'm a big fan of the plus 10 damage AC-10s. I just can't really find them in my playthrough for some reason. They are rare as rocking horse shit. But yeah, they're worth getting your hands on, aren't they? Especially when you pull off those one-shot headshots. Great fun. Now, what are we doing? Do we have more missions here? We do. We've got one more mission here. Destroy base Badlands. All right, that's fine. We can go for that. Should I take the heavies out again? I think I might. And also, before I travel, I need to remember to fit those new weapons into mechs, because there's definitely mechs can make use of them. Right, so everybody got injured apart from Cold Steel. That's fine. We'll keep Cold Steel in. Let's bring in Alto. Let's bring in Rylan. And I need someone else. What else have I got here? So, it's a bit hot for this. I don't know. Yeah, maybe I'll stick Grom in. Grom hasn't done a mission today, has he? Okay, so Alto, Rylan, Cold Steel, Grom. Yeah, it looks alright to me. Okay, deploy. Oh, Tasku says show us one after I've launched. I've read that. So I think I've got one on one of my King Crabs, maybe. I know one of the King Crabs has got a plus 5 damage one because You know, I've hardly found any of the plus 10 damage. So I was making do with a plus 5 damage. I mean, that's still worthy of a one-shot kill. Because what you need is 61 damage to single-shot headshot a mech when it's out of cover with no damage mitigation at all. So obviously the plus 5 damage AC-10 does 65 damage, so that takes it over the threshold, so that's worth having as well. I've either got one on the Harry Lander or one on one of my two King Crabs, but I definitely hardly seen any of them. And you know, in the vanilla, you just encounter more mechs in the late game that have those AC-10s and have improved versions of them. And because there's a wider variety of mechs in this, and probably ones that aren't carrying those improved weapons, perhaps that makes it harder to get hold of them. I don't know. I'm just speculating. But one thing I'm sure of is you see a lot less of them. So if you do see them in the shop, they're precious. Buy them. As HBFT says, he almost bankrupted himself to buy one. I would do the same. I think it's worth it. So the next best thing to a Gauss rifle, in my opinion. Oh, Cold Steel says, low spirits, what happened? I'm usually an upbeat kind of guy. Yeah, you and Sarge had a fight and I bollocked you both. That's pretty much the, the short yeah. version of it. What can I do you for? I thought it was the right thing to do, to bring you both in for a chat and sort things out, but it resulted in you both having low spirits. Right, what we got here? 60, 60, 70. Yeah, that's the one to worry about. Might be an archer. Standing by. I really don't like this map. Because the approach, maybe it's just the approach I take, but there's just barely any cover. I mean, even if you go this way, it's a struggle. I've been sensor locked. I always tend to come this way because going this way, it takes longer and you end up getting shot by the base turrets for longer. I know you can kind of cover hop if you've got a fast enough mech to make it from there to there, but and then from there to there, and then from there up here to here into these trees. Once you're in those trees, yeah, you're doing all right from that position. But yeah, I always tend to go around this way and it's just so open, there's no cover. I always end up regretting it, but it is quicker than going the other way. Right now, most of what I've got in this lance are brawlers, so I just need to kind of go at the enemy and try to take them out quickly. Gonna have to be relying on some evasion here. Working out so far for Ryland. Only a handful of missiles actually connecting with him. Still, that's his evasion reduced now.
Ready for orders. No shooting, just running. Got it.
All right, everybody, let's get this done.
Ah, Tasku says he's getting some lag on the stream. Yeah, I don't know what's going on today. Normally, everything is fine. I've only had one other stream where I had problems with the stream lagging. And that was because there was a YouTube video upload going on at the same time, which I wasn't aware of. Shell had set going. Now, that isn't the case today. And I've turned off absolutely everything I can think of that could be causing. And I've been getting warnings of drop frames all session. I've only got an hour to go now. So after that, I'll have to see what it was. But no idea what's causing it. So sorry if you're getting drop frames at the moment. Otto says he forgot about Brexit. Yeah, Brexit is causing me to have drop frames. That's definitely got to be it. I think he's right.
Roger.
Yeah, it's a weird one. I mean, I've shut everything down as well. Like, normally, you know, normally I can stream with, like, 16 Google tabs open and all sorts of other stuff going on in the background, and it's fine. I've got Google completely closed. I've closed everything. Like, but the only thing that's running apart from Streamlabs and the game is TeamSpeak right now. I think it's unlikely that TeamSpeak would be causing it. I'm pretty sure it's impossible for that to be causing it, but I'll close that down as well, just in case. But that's the last thing I've got left to close down. I've no idea what is causing it. It could just be something going on with my internet connection, or something that's going on with Shell's stuff that I'm not aware of. But I, like I said, I did ask her earlier, and she said there's nothing happening, so I don't know what it is. No, it's not that, Hotto. Right, let's keep shooting this Warhammer up.
That hit something good.
Yeah, the ads are annoying, aren't they, Tusky?
Hey, losing armor over here.
How might I help?
What's going on? What are we fighting? A Warhammer, a dragon, and an Ostrock. Okay. Not really been paying attention to the fight so far. I should, though, because I'm out in the open. At least I've managed to get vigilance on two of my pilots. So we've got a little bit of protection. It does mean, however, that I can't spare vigilance on any precision strikes or the like. And also, I can't really afford to do it with Cold Steel because he's in low spirits right now and it'll just eat up too much. I'm going to keep focusing on that Warhammer since we've started on him. He obviously is not enjoying himself because he's backing away now.
Take that. I've been sensor locked.
Oh, crap. Oh, this is where it gets nasty. Roiland getting a taste of his own medicine here from the base turrets. Normally he's dishing out the LRM damage. Now he's just receiving it. Still, we can rotate who's on the front line and try to get that damage spread a bit. So Alto is going to be the new front line. This is kind of worrying. I'm dangerously close to getting punched in the face by a dragon. I don't like this. I don't like this at all. Shoot the dragon then, I guess.
Waiting for orders. On the move.
Man, I need to nail that turret as well. Well, everything needs to die all at once, basically. That's how it is, as usual. Do you know what? I might precision strike with Rylan here. I'm really kind of scared of... Like, dragons, when they're shooting at me, not scary at all. Not even bothered by dragons. But when they're close enough to punch a pilot out of the cockpit in one, very, very nervous about being near them. Ryland's getting smashed up there because he's not got vigilance. I went for the precision strike instead, you see, just to try to get this dragon wrecked. He's open CT now, yes, which is in. Progress. Ah, oh, can't quite get in machine gun range. That's annoying. I need to keep shooting this dragon up, though. Absolutely have to keep the firepower going into him. Go on, hit the center. There we go. We've got one large laser in the center. Left torso gone as well. Are you talking about The Expanse, Tasku? Because if you're talking about The Expanse, it's awesome, and I love that series.
Standing by.
That'll definitely help your aim, Cold Steel. Oh, man. Okay. Come on, Grom. Get this dragon down. 66 hit points remaining. It's unlikely, isn't it? Come on. Is that it? I think he's done it. Yes, he's done it. Whew. Okay. Well, I mean, that's only one of the problems resolved because we've still got this, what is it? Ostrock flanking on the left side there that could get around into the rear arc of my stuff, which I'm kind of worried about. So having Alto at the front line is working out now. The turrets are bombarding the Bombardier. Hey. Instead of smashing Rylan up this time, which is what we wanted. Rylan's already taken a turn on the front line to get smashed by two heavy LRM turrets, and they do a lot of damage.
It's on now.
Alright, Alto. I think I might keep Alto on the front line a little bit longer. This is risky. I'm doing it. It's happening. Just exposing the back of Alto to that Ostrock. This is not smart. Don't do this. Don't watch me doing this and think, oh, well, Doyle got away with that. It must be a good idea. It's not a good idea. This is a really, really bad idea. I just really also would quite like to kill this Warhammer as quickly as possible. So I've got somewhere I can start facing my rear. I've got base turrets there. I've got a Warhammer there. I've got an Ostrock there. There's only like this little window here where I can face the rear of my mechs, but I want to keep advancing because I've got brawlers, and the longer I mess about and don't advance on these turrets, the more volleys of LRMs I'm going to take, which is obviously not good for the health of any of my mechs. Plus, there's usually reinforcements coming from somewhere over here as well on this mission, so I'm anticipating having to fight more mechs on top. So this is why I'm taking the risk here. I'm judging it as being worthwhile to try to kill this guy, which we've achieved. Just in the name of taking less damage and keeping the advance going. There we go. Where's he going to shoot? Okay, it's fine. He's shooting Rylan. Well, I say it's fine. Rylan's got no protection right now and has already taken a volley in that side, but at least it wasn't shooting Alto in the back. That could have been worse. Okay. All right. Can we get Cold Steel and his machine guns into play? I think we can. Yeah, we can. All right, let's angle like that.
Okay, I'm on it.
And we're going to have to switch the medium laser off. But at least we get the 5-4 machine guns, and he's actually got a good chance of hitting with those. This guy is fresh, so all we're doing is wearing him down a bit, but it's worth it. I mean, those machine guns, especially the improved ones in this mod, it's just worth damage, you know. I could do with getting the maxed out improved ones. These are only slightly improved, but
ready for orders.
If you get those ones that give you like +2 damage, they're awesome. Right, now I want to position Rylan carefully. I don't want to do this. I guess I'll face him like that. Again, I want to get those small lasers into play. I'm going to vent some heat, and we're going to go for a precision strike with absolutely everything aimed at the center torso of this Ostrock. Again, really just wanting to kill things as quickly as possible here, so I'm taking that over protection right now. Is he gone? He's gone. Good. Whew, good job, Rylan. Right, so now,
ready for orders.
I don't know if that came through or not, but I just said now, and then behind me, one of the cats just went meow. But no, not now, meow. Now, kill turrets is what I was going to say.
Confirmed.
What are you doing, eh? I'm trying to talk to the stream. Right, meow. That's right. What's up, Willow? Can I come up? No, you just want to stare at me. Okay. All right, let's start work on this heavy LRM turret. Let's vent some heat. That is a great movie. Jaime Donga says, show the cat. Oh, you've all seen the cat before. Well, one of two cats. And the internet loves cats.
I'm under heavy fire.
There
you go. Show them what you get.
Aren't you gonna stand on the keyboard? Oh dear. Look, Willow. Up there. She doesn't want to sit upright. There we go. Okay. You're all confused by this now, aren't you? What's going on?
Waiting orders.
Right, let's go for a vigilance sprint with Alto. Let's get him into position.
Warning.
What's up there?
Enemy reinforcements detected.
There we go. Maybe if I move my keyboard. She likes sitting on keyboards, but I don't want to let her sit on my keyboard. Can you sit upright? You're going to step on the keyboard. Yeah. There we go. No, get off my keyboard, damn it. Stop, cat, stop. Okay, that's enough. Enough pressing of keys. You're gonna break the stream.
Standing by.
Okay, let's sprint Ryland as well.
Confirmed.
Willow, seriously. That is not me moving the camera. That is Willow moving the camera. Are you quite finished?
Ready for orders.
I don't know, is that... Does that pick up? No. You need to purr louder, Willow. They can't hear you. No, it's not loud enough. I put the microphone right by her. She is purring. You'll have to take my word for it. But not loud enough to be picked up.
Double time. Let's go.
Oh, I can't reach the space bar now to speed these moves up. There we go. Can you hit the space bar for me, Willow? Do you know what the space bar is? Ah, look at all that evasion. Oh, I think Alto avoided every single one of those missiles there. Look at that circle of black explosions around him, but nothing actually hit him. I think I'm just going to stand Grom where he is and finish off this LRM turret.
Engaging with target.
Otto says, that's not so bad, Doyle. My cat tried to back shoot a teammate on MWO with my quad LBX 10 Cyclops. Oops. I bet that went down well. I would like to, Hotto, but right now I can't allow you. I can't type the command to give you permission to link, because my cat's in the way of my damn keyboard. You having fun now? Yeah.
All right, everybody, let's get this done.
What's the plan?
Right, there's another LRM turret somewhere. I don't know where it is, but it needs to go wherever it is. Oh, crap. Also, enemy reinforcements. Oh, they're over there still. All right, maybe we've got time. Need to get these turrets. Also need spacebar. Thank you, Willow. All right, heavy LRM turret. Oh my god, really? I thought there were two. I didn't realize there were three LRM turrets. All right, that's kind of scary. Let's shoot this one.
Turret destroyed.
Now what?
Commander?
Oh, God. I suppose Rylan.
Coordinates received.
Can you shoot this turret for me, Rylan? Please. Kill it in one.
Got it.
Please kill it in one. Oh, now I'm getting itchy nose. You make my nose itch, cat.
One less turret.
That's right. It's all that fur you've got.
Good to go.
Right, now what? Cold steel. Maybe I'll just sprint cold steel over towards this cover here. Because somebody's got to start facing off these reinforcements. We've just got one more turret to kill, and then my back can safely be aimed at the base, and I can face
standing by
the reinforcement stuff. Okay, what do we see? One of those was 55 tons. That's 45 tons, so just a Lancer mediums. We're all right. We got this. We got this. No worries. Oh, and a 75 tonner.
I'm showing minor damage.
You have orders?
Okay. I think I'll use Alto to smash this last turret.
Be there in a jiff.
Heavy shredder turret. Nasty. Oh, she's had enough. Hey, I've got my keyboard back. Askew says, is this the longest mission in the game? No.
One
oh, what was my record? Was it 39 rounds? Something like that. We did one that was something stupidly long. And like I'd run out of ammo and everything. 38 rounds, Sarge says. There you go. That was my longest mission. That was an eternity.
Roger that.
Right, finally, we can start shooting at these reinforcements. Cold steel is first into the fight. What are we up against? Phoenix Hawk. Hunchback 4P. That's the wrong mech for this environment, mate. Shadowhawk 2H. And a Stalker 4P. Okay. Quite how that Stalker snuck into this medium, Lance. I'm not sure, but... Alright. We'll deal with it. I guess I'll have to take the extra hit for the low spirits, but I do need to give Cold Steel vigilance. He needs it because he's going to be frontlining it for at least a turn against a full lance of mechs. So we'll do that and then we'll fire the large lasers at the 4P. The 4P obviously by far the biggest threat from these three mechs, so any reducing of its firepower or killing of it we can do is good. After that Hunchback 4P is pretty scary, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna burn himself out. He'll end up running too hot after a couple of turns. King Killjoy, hello, how you doing?
Commander?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna run Grom into cover here. We'll shoot next time around. At least he gets to lose a load of heat, which is handy as well. No, it really was that long, Katasku. It was ridiculous. I mean, I had, like, my mechs were being held together with string by that point, and I had at least one mech had run out of ammo. In fact, I think almost everybody was almost out of ammo or out of ammo. I was just down to either punching or energy weapons. The LRM mech that I had definitely completely run out. And yeah, it was, I can't remember what episode it was, but yeah, it was definitely edge of the seat stuff by the time I was fighting the last group of enemies, because I didn't have very much left to work with. Right, keeping the right side protected a little on cold steel now. We're going to go for vigilance again. And this time, just going to shoot up the hunchback with cold steel. And then I'll probably drill everybody else into the stalker. That's right, Sirian. Yeah, it was after that mission that I decided to add the 9th ton of LRM ammo. That's right, yeah. Because, you know, some people might say, and they'd be wrong too, in my opinion, that 8 tons of LRM ammo is too many tons of LRM ammo. But I beg to differ. I think 9 tons is the right amount after that damn mission. Because I don't ever want to run out of LRM ammo. I don't want to have to be running up and trying to punch things with one of my mechs. And we haven't run out of LRM ammo since, have we? That's in case you're wondering what I'm on about, that's 9 tons of LRM ammo to 4 LRM-15 launchers. So that's the exact amount that I'm using. Right, we need this stalker to die, don't we? Are we going to precision strike this, Rylan? Are we? Should we? I think we should. Let's try to get this guy killed quickly. Alto, you're a little bit far away from the fight, aren't you? Let's go sprinting. Again, good opportunity to lose some heat on him. Sirian, I used to run 3 LRM-20s on Stalkers. That was something that I've done in this campaign earlier on in it. I got sick of Stalkers and started using other stuff, because we went through a phase where we just had loads of Stalkers. I had so many Stalkers and I kind of got sick of them. And then, yeah, I think the first one I switched up to was the Awesome, just for a change. And I put 4 LRM-15s in an Awesome to start with. And then I decided, you know what? I've not done that in ages and I actually really like it. So I built a Highlander with 4 LRM-15s that I've used ever since. And I do really like that. I'd used it before, like, oh man, I can't even remember how long ago. Like, within the first few months of the game coming out, I'd built a Highlander like that, I think. Way, way back. But I'd stopped using it for... Why did I stop using them? I think I stopped using LRM boats because it was too easy mode at the time to just knock stuff down to death. I stopped doing that. But then with this game, with this playthrough, I thought, yeah, I'll just do a whole bunch of different things, some of which I've you know, done in the past and gotten bored of using. And then we had the longbow as well. When we got our hands on a longbow, I had that running with 4 LRM-15s too. And it's pretty much the same build as I have in the Highlander. Same amount of ammo. The only real difference is, obviously, it's 5 tons lighter, so it's got a bit less armor. And I think less heat sinks. That was the only real difference. It's still heat efficient enough, though. Okay, I see how it is. We've got a Phoenix Hawk trying to flank and be a pain in the ass. Maybe I'll let him be a pain in the ass because he can't really do that much damage. Oh, I can't get close enough to use my machine guns on the Hunchback, though. Oh, well, that settles it. I guess you're getting shot then, Phoenix Hawk.
On my way.
Yeah, the short bow, that was fun, wasn't it? That was another one named by Sarge. That was basically a long bow, but with SRMs instead of LRMs. You see what we did there? And that had, was it 7 SRM4s? Pretty brutal, but just nowhere near as brutal as that Stalker I was using earlier. So that got put away eventually, and the Stalker stayed out. I think that's the only Stalker I kept out in the end. Oh no, bad times. Oh, 80 damage melee attack.
I'm taking heavy hits, Commander.
We don't want that hitting Ryland in the cockpit, do we?
Barely hit, Commander.
I'm hit. Oh, I'm hit.
Okay. So, what's happening here is the brawlers, thanks to the improved AI, are being more of a pain in the ass than they would normally be in vanilla. And that's a good thing, because it makes life interesting. But from my point of view right now, that's a little bit problematic, because
good to go.
They're right up in my face and punching, and we can't have that. I've got to focus this Hunchback down. I wanted to kill that damn Stalker. What is left of this Stalker? Too much. Ugh. Because, I mean, that's still a priority in a way because it does so much damage, but now this Hunchback 4P is right up in my face. I can't afford to let that live for another turn because it could potentially just outright kill one of my pilots at any moment. So I've got to deal with that, because at the very least, although the Stalker will do a lot of damage, it's not going to just outright kill someone. Right, let's switch off the medium lasers. We'll use the small lasers. They do more damage anyway.
Engaging target.
Otto says, remember when Doyle was like, oh, the reinforcements are just a lance of mediums. Yeah. I remember that. We're going to be fine. I just need to make sure this Hunchback 4P goes down before he does any more melee damage to anyone. I mean, also, he's standing right in Gromulus's rear. And, I mean, that's never a good idea, is it? But it's also not a very safe position for Grom to be in. Right, cloud of missiles time. 59 damage needed on that center torso. No resolve to aim it with. I'm going to need more than this, I think. Fingers crossed for luck, but I think I'm going to need more than that. Yeah. So someone else is going to have to shoot him now. Where is he at? 4 hit points, really? Oh no, 4 hit points remaining. Right, okay. Well, Grom is going to have to finish the job.
I copy.
Come on, Grom.
Firing all weapons.
That looked like one of them hit CT. There we go, good stuff. Right, because less worried about that Phoenix Hawk, because I don't think that Phoenix Hawk has a very high melee attack, so I can afford for that to be amongst things, unless it starts shooting people in the back, which it's not doing for now. So next thing will be back to shooting up that Stalker. Yeah, I mean, look, yeah, whatever, Phoenix Hawk, you do that, I don't care. Right, we do need to move Cold Steel, though, because he's now opened on his left torso. So let's angle him No. Let's angle him like this. There we go. Let's hide that left side a little.
Moving to position.
Doesn't have coolant vents, so I'm going to have to reduce what I'm firing right now. But we'll still get away with two large lasers, which might just be enough to take a side torso off here, which will be helpful.
Taking the ship.
Or he could just shoot the armoured locations of the leg and the arm. That's less useful. Now that Stalker's going to get another full volley in. Oh, you've only got yourself to blame here, Cold Steel. He's shooting at you. You could have knocked half that mech off. It's all right. He's fine. He's not got much armor, but he's fine. And the Stalker decided that was worth a shutdown as well.
Yes, Commander.
All right, then.
How might I help?
Guess we need to try to take advantage of that. Move Alto up to the front.
Confirmed.
He's going to have to reduce his firepower slightly. Let's switch that one off. And thanks to the shutdown, we can go for a precision strike. I'm going to aim for that center, even though it's 40%, because a bunch of missiles are going to hit that side torso anyway. So rather than just straight up aim for the side torso, we may as well go for the extra chance of doing some more CT damage. And look, we blame the side torso off anyhow, even though we weren't aiming for it. Yeah, Alto loves that voice.
Ready for orders.
The super bad guy voice. Right, what am I going to do here? We're running a little bit toasty with Rylan. And it's two turns until I can cool down. But also not much armor left in a lot of locations. I'm really tempted to run up and punch that Phoenix Hawk. But then that will leave Rylan right out front and he'll probably get shot to pieces next turn. Instead, let's pull back here. Hopefully hiding him behind the thug a little, and we'll switch off a bunch of weapons. 3 SRM6s isn't bad. Yeah, because I want to make the most of this guy being shut down. What's he got? 3 hit points left on the CT. Oh man, yeah, we're definitely doing this. Oh, that's the Stalker dealt with.
Target eliminated.
Right. Now, Grom. Maybe Grom can do some punching. Right, I'm going to give him vigilance because he's going to be at the front and probably get shot by the Shadowhawk. But I'm going to run up and punch this guy in the face. I mean, I do have coolant vents, so I could lose my heat that way. But that's less fun to do that and shoot than it is to just run up and punch the Phoenix Hawk in the face. It's been a while since we've done any melee attack at all. 110 damage here, potential. And let's hope for a cockpit shot. Go, go, Grom. Here comes the thug. Oh, goes for the headbutt. It's not the cockpit, but I think that was the entire left side of that mech taken out there. Yep, that'll do. Yeah, run away, Phoenix Hawk. That's what you get. And yeah, 60% damage reduction thanks to the vigilance we popped. And Grom just laughs off that damage from the Shadowhawk. Not scared of that. Right.
Good to go.
Rylan. Oh man. Everybody's running so hot still.
Awaiting orders.
Okay, let's vent some heat with Alto. And precision strike the crap out of this Shadowhawk. This might even kill him. I mean, the Shadowhawk doesn't have a lot of armor in the center and is a little bit explodey. And there he goes. So,
hope we
just half a Phoenix Hawk left to deal with now. I think we're going to be just fine. Who should I deal with it with, though? Cold Steel? Yeah, why not? Let's see if we can get those machine guns into play.
Move order received.
Can I switch on another large? Oh, too hot. Medium, yes. So two larges, a medium, and four machine guns.
Roger that.
That'll put a dent in him. not really getting away with firing much this turn, is he, Ryland? Just two SRM6s. Next turn he can vent coolant, but I'm hoping this guy will be dead before that happens. Well, we've still got Grom. Oh, we could melee with Grom again. Should we do it? Should we do it? Yeah, I want to do it. I want to go for another melee attack. Go thug. Right leg destroyed this time. Oh, that poor Phoenix Hawk. He's getting stomped. What are you going to do now? I mean, all he can do is a half-assed melee attack. Is that what he's going for? Where's he going? Is that all you've got? Just, oh, I guess I'll just run into the middle then and just die. that's his entire plan. Okay. Well, let's make this fun. Switch everything on Rylan and go nuts. Yeah. Obliterated. Right, we've still got to kill the buildings, though, after all of that. Man, this mission feels a lot longer than it was. It does annoy me, these base destruction ones. Like, once you've killed all the enemies, just let the mission end. Don't force me to kill buildings. I mean, it's fine that it's there if you want to be a wuss and kill the buildings and run away. You know, that's fine if you want to do that, but if you actually stay in the fight and kill all of the enemies, you should just assume that everyone killed the buildings afterwards and just allow the mission to end. There's no need for this.
Target destroyed. Ready for orders.
Oh wow, I get to use multi-target. Oh, you're joking? That's got 55 hit points. Oh, alright, I'll have to use two large lasers for this then.
Multiple enemies locked in. Target site demolished.
Ready for orders. I'm there.
Let's get Cold Steel, hopefully, to finish the job. 50 hit points remaining. Yes, he's going to manage this, surely. Yeah, there we go. The extra weapons were in case of misses. All good. Cold Steel says, oh no, this is fun. Set the buildings on fire and then use my machine guns to shoot down the pirates as they flee. Bloodthirsty. Uh, Tasku says, I would also like the option to skip animations, like waiting for missiles to hit and buildings to explode. There are some settings that you can do that they added into the game, aren't there, that allow you to skip some things. I forget now because I never use them. But the one that does annoy me is what we just saw, is when you destroy a building and it does that slow camera zoom in on the flaming building and you're like, oh yeah, all right, we've seen that a million times. I'd like to be able to just hit spacebar to skip that in the same way as I can, you know, speed up the mech movements with spacebar. Right, we may as well take a piece of Hunchback 4P, finish one of those. Piece of Warhammer, we get a whole one of those. Something else to sell. Looking for weapons. Wow, there's really nothing that I want particularly. Already got enough stability damage PPCs. I prefer the damage ones. Anyhow. Yeah, that's kind of underwhelming. You're heaviest. Let's take a piece of you. Cold Steel says, yeah, but there's nothing worse than the long animations during travel. Yeah, kind of with you there. I mean, it's probably loading stuff or something. I don't know what it's doing or why they put it in every time you travel, but it's nice to see, you know, when you first get the game, it's like, oh, that's cool. Nice little cutscene. It would be even nicer if you could just skip it once you've played like over 1,000 hours of the game and seen it over and over. I would love to be able to skip it. Cool. All right, let's send that to storage. That to storage. We've got some repairs to do. Samurai says, well, there is a mod that can skip most of them, all but the actual FTL travel. Ah, that would be what I want to skip. Or you can press escape. Does that actually skip it? Is that right? Is that, am I learning something new here? Can you skip the FTL travel by hitting escape, Samurai? Please confirm or deny what you're saying here, because that's a revelation to me if you can skip it that way. Oh, right, just the docking, undocking, and orbit. Right, I see. I see. Right, let's spend some XP. So,
yes, Commander.
Alto, not ready yet. Black Cat, not ready yet. Cold Steel, come on, he's been on a bunch of missions. There we go, we can get another point in Guts. He's now all the more survivable. He can take 4 injuries. But I'm going to have to save up quite a bit to get Coolant Vent. Once I've done that, we'll go up the gunnery tree and things, well, life will get a little bit easier, but yeah, for now, Guts 7, he's all guts and not a lot else at the moment, just a walking gut. Who else? Emperor Krang, yes, he can level up as well, more piloting. He's only 2 points away from maxing himself out, which would be great. What else we got? Anyone else been out on a mission today? Shell went out on a mission. We'll save to max Shell's gunnery. Okay. So, we will travel somewhere, but where is the question? Are there any flashpoints I could leave myself in position to do? Yeah, there's a whole bunch that I've not got around to doing. Oh, what? I never got around to doing the Steel Beast. Really? Okay. Alright, that's the Razorbacks one. What's this one? Oh, yeah, the prisoner transfer. Right, I remember that.
This is
Okay, yep. And... okay. I kind of want to travel to this one, I guess. That's 32 days. That's quite a long old travel. Ah, yes. I need to refit Max. I very nearly forgot. Now then, where were we? So I've got an improved large laser. Definitely picked up one of those. The thug could do with one more. Okay, let's refit the thug then. So... there we go. That's that maxed out now. Awesome. The thug finally has all the good stuff. You probably forgot to put a space after your full stop, Hotto.
Right.
The bot is also a grammar Nazi because it looks like a link if you don't put a space after your full stop. It looks like actually it was a comma after an exclamation mark that screwed you. Definitely full on grammar Nazi. this, for those that are wondering, that's what he typed. There you go. Save him doing it. Right, so we got the large laser in. I've got improved SRM6s to fit out on things, haven't I? Did we ever give this? Hold on. All right, let me just check my components before I start going through the slow process of opening up mechs and realizing I haven't got what I thought I had. Yeah, so I haven't got any improved SRM6s. What about machine guns? Plus one damage and only a couple of them. Barely really worth adjusting at this point. What about medium lasers? I definitely got one plus 10 damage medium laser. So I now have two of those. All right. So... who has not got improved medium lasers? Well, the catapult for a start, I noticed earlier. Yeah, so let's refit the A1. Nice. So that takes him up to 322 damage. Obviously, that will go up even more if I can improve those SRM6s at some point. But not yet. We've used all the good stuff for now. I've used a lot of SRM6s. In my mech bay, there are a lot of SRM armed mechs, I think, right now. Okay. Right, I think we're good. So now we'll start the travel. And we're going to go here. So this is only a 3-skull flashpoint, so I'll probably not be using my assaults for that when it comes to it. So, Hotto, you've got Rogue Tech you're installing on your laptop, and then you've got BattleTech Extended on your PC, is that right? I'm pretty sure if you're going for your crazy challenge on Rogue Tech, you're going to have an even harder time than you're already having with Battletech Extended. That's full on crazy. Not that what you're doing already isn't, but if there's something that's beyond crazy, then it's that. Both of those things. What's going on here? Yes, let her keep working at it. Shell suffers an injury. Oh dear. That's not good. No, sorry, Cold Steel. The game didn't freeze. I was just tabbed out looking because I'm not going to have time to do another mission at this point. So I was looking to see who we can raid when I wrap things up. So what I'm going to do is I'll arrive at Herotitus and then we'll leave ourselves there so we can go through the flashpoint in tomorrow's session. So ordinarily I would be doing another stream in a couple of hours time, but I'm not going to do one tonight. So I will be back tomorrow at the usual time of 3 p.m. UK time or 10 a.m. Eastern if you're in the States or Canada. And I will be back with more Battletech Extended 3025. But we're just going to arrive here. And then we'll do the sign-off thing. And then if anyone is nice enough to want to hang around for a little bit longer and join a raid, we'll go raid somebody. And I see somebody that we've not raided before. But first thing I want to do, since I'm here, and I'll probably forget next session, is check the store in case there's anything cool. So let's have a look. No, nothing cool. Okay, so we're all good. We're all set for next time. All right, well, thank you very much for watching, everyone. Really good to see so many of you back after I've been off ill. I really appreciate you all coming back and not just going, ah, screw that guy. We found someone else to watch. But yeah, thanks so much. And thank you to the new follows as well. Really appreciate that. And the raid from Codeine and the bits and everything. All of you, you're very much appreciated. And of course, thanks most of all to my subscribers. I really appreciate you guys supporting me doing this. You're all so much fun to have around as well. So thanks to everyone. I will be back tomorrow at the usual time, as I just said, of 3 p.m. UK time or 10 a.m. Eastern if you're in Canada or the States. And I will see you tomorrow. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget, please give it a thumbs up or a thumbs down, depending on what you thought of the content. And subscribe to the channel for more stuff like this. Thanks again, and I'll see you all tomorrow.